NBC Sports presents the College Bowl season, featuring the best in college football postseason action. Today, from Pasadena, California, Michigan versus USC. In the 1979 Rose Bowl. The Rose Bowl is brought to you by Chrysler Plymouth. By Budweiser, the king of beers. When you say Budweiser, you've said it all. By Goodyear, developers of such tire innovations as the new all-season Tiempo radio. And by IBM, helping put information to work for people.
We didn't break 250 great bands people out to the West Coast to see Michigan get beat again, did we?
No!
I said, did we?
No!
Did we?
No!
Let's go!
I'd like to win this game. I would say maybe it's as important a game as we played because of the circumstances. You don't know how often you can come out here. This is the third time in a row we've been out here and we haven't won. So I'd like to win this game very much. Maybe selfishly I would. But I do know this. If I win this game, they'll find something else in my background that I haven't been able to do.
For this group, it's the culmination of a great season. We started off kind of down a little bit, have had a great season emotionally. It's a together team. It seems to me we deserve to win.
NBC Sports, welcome to the 1979 Rose Bowl. Brought to you by Datsun. Invites you to see the only front-wheel drive backed by Datsun quality. The all-new 310 at your Datsun dealers now.
Hello, I'm O.J. Simpson. You know, 1978 was sort of a transition year for me. I became a 49er and also became a member of the NBC sports team. Now, today's the first day of 1979, and what better way to start my association with the National Broadcasting Company than with its telecast of the Rose Bowl. Now, I'm standing in Heritage Hall on the USC campus, and believe me, there's a lot of memories stored in here. I won this little baby about 10 years ago. It was also 10 years ago that I played it in the Rose Bowl. 10 years, you must be getting old, Juice. Ryan Gumbel had the opportunity to visit with two All-Americans, Charles White of USC and Rick Leach of Michigan, two very fine representatives of their university. And later, I'm gonna show you something I bet you've never seen before, a team's final practice before the Rose Bowl. So why don't you make yourself comfortable, get what you need, because we're gonna be back in a minute.
Charles White, as the USC tailback, has not only followed in the footsteps of Garrett, Davis, Bell, and myself, he has outshone us all. Oh, well. In this, just his junior year, he has become the greatest runner in the history of a school famous for its runners. Brian Gummel spoke to him just the other day.
Charlie, you grew up in San Fernando. You had a chance to see all the great USC tailbacks come through. Certainly, you've heard about all of them, having been heir to the throne. The first of the great ones really was Mike Garrett, and he's the guy you worked with this past spring.
Yes, Mike came down during the spring, and he helped me with working on what to do after I get to football, and helped me all along during this past season.
Mike Garrett was the first of the superstar Trojan tailbacks. Compact runner, he made John McKay's eye work at SC and set the pattern for the others to follow, a pattern of consistency and tireless energy.
O.J. Simpson was another of the great USC tailbacks.
Running with the fluid style of a high-stepping sprinter, O.J. Simpson also took his place in the line of great Trojan tailbacks. Wearing number 32, he led the Cardinal in gold to a national championship under John McKay.
As a scout, write a scouting report on O.J., his abilities. How do you see it?
Well, first of all, if I was a scout, I would look at O.J.'s size, first of all, and his quickness. I feel that he'd hit the hole awfully quick, and he's a tough man to maintain.
Of course, he had fantastic speed.
That's right.
Anthony Davis was one you are very, very close to. He went to the same high school.
Wearing number 28, he came out of the San Fernando Valley with a high-stepping style to lead the Trojans to two national championships.
It's so many things that Anthony helped me on. He used to play catch with us a lot, and it's just so many things. You know, I look at him right now as more or less a big brother to me.
Let's talk about another great USC tailback you got a chance to study up close.
Ricky Bell. Wearing number 42, he was not as elusive as Garrett, as fast as OJ, or as high-stepping as AD, but he was just as effective.
He influenced me a little to run, be a physical runner, that is. I was more of a scat back who just wanted to run away from everything.
Is anything as emotional as playing in Pasadena in the Rose Bowl against a Big Ten champion?
I enjoyed playing in the Rose Bowl. I only had one experience there, but I enjoy playing the Rose Bowl because the fact is so many people are watching, and there's just something about being there in that area, being there in Pasadena makes me feel good.
And there's something special about being the USC tailback and being at center stage.
Something special.
This has Charles White been the main man of the Trojan offense, so has Rick Leach been the main staple of the Wolverines. He has been for 4 years, throwing for over 4,000 yards, rushing for over 2,000, and accounting for 81 touchdowns in the Michigan uniform.
Rick, let's play word association for a moment. If I say Rose Bowl, what comes to mind?
Better be victory this year.
You have accounted for more touchdowns than anybody in college football history. More total yards than any man in college football history. Do you think you've received the proper recognition for that?
Well, that's not really for me to say. I was just proud to play with the guys that I have at Michigan. I've always been the guy that really hasn't worried that much about stats and what's going on. All I care about really is winning.
Rick, why did you go to Michigan? If you can think back to about 4 or 5 years ago when you made the decision.
Well, there was a lot of reasons, but mainly, I'd been brought up with Michigan blood in me. My father played baseball at Michigan. He played on their national championship baseball team in 1952, so I was kind of always brought up with a little Michigan blood in me. And when I was looking at the colleges, one of the things that I was looking at was a school that was going to let me play both football and baseball.
Your running style, how would you characterize it?
Well, I think the thing that probably characterizes me is I run scared. I'm not as big as most people are. I'm probably not as fast as most people are. I have pretty good quickness, and I try and get out in the open field and dodge around a little bit. When you run scared, you don't let those big guys hit you too much.
Would you characterize yourself as elusive?
Yes, I'd say, you know, I'm pretty quick. I try and move around a lot on the option, and we try and find out what their free safety is going to do, how he's going to be supporting, how he covers on pass coverage and so forth. And hopefully we can get him running to support the option, and I can cut in behind him a few times.
Final question. Beating Ohio State in Columbus is a big deal. Would it be bigger than beating USC in the Rose Bowl?
At the time it was, because that was we had to win the game to win the Big Ten championship and to come out here. But now that that's passed, no, the USC game is going to be the biggest college game of Rick Leach's life. People have tagged me because of our bowl losses as a guy that couldn't win the last game, and I wouldn't want it any other way. Now we feel that USC has as good or better college football team than anybody in the country, and they're going to be a great challenge for our team, and the win for Rick Leach and Michigan in the Rose Bowl would mean a great deal.
Center over his head will kill you right out in the field.
Okay, let's get our punt return team out. Punt return team out. Punt team stay. Punt team stay. Punt team stay. First defense, punt return. First defense, punt return. Time.
This is the last practice for the USC team before the game. It's the day before the game, and actually they're not really working out that hard. What they're doing is going over mental assignments. They're going over all their special teams. They want to make sure that everybody's in the right place and everybody knows what they want to do. Actually, if you're not ready today, hey, you're not going to be ready tomorrow. This may be the last practice for these seniors, and tomorrow may be the last game in a Trojan uniform. But you know, when I was at SC, we had a little saying. You can go to UCLA and be a Bruin for 4 years. You can go to whatever school and be whatever it is for 4 years. But when you go to USC, you're a Trojan for life.
You've got to stay outside. We got you nailed inside one time. Stay outside, watch the ball snapped and who it snapped to. Now watch who it snapped to. We've been good all year. Let's just make sure we concentrate. Huh? Concentrate and fight like hell. If you get held off, fight like hell to get back in your lane. Don't be too eager now. If the guy fair catches it, don't have a collision with him. Okay, good, 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 good. One more time, one more time. Let's do it again, offense, one more time.
Come on, you're coming in here with this.
Hey, any guys ever worn that uniform, hey, we're proud of that we were SC Trojans. We're proud of you. They'll be cheering for you tomorrow. I'll be up in the booth trying not to be biased.
The world looks at you. 70 million people watch you play tomorrow. 20 million of them are ex-Trojans, or at least wish they were ex-Trojans. You've been sensational. Let's make them go out in style. Let's make them go out in style. Bring the band on. Bring the band on. Oh! Oh! For our seniors at the last practice they have on this field, it's an honor that we kind of run them off in a one by one, if you will. We have our team form a line between here and the gate. If you kind of join in that group, play conquest for us, yeah. We'll run off. Hey, the finest group of seniors I've ever been around. If you'll do that for us, let's get it going. Okay, hey.
The executive producer of NBC Sports is Don Ohlmeyer. Pre-Rose Bowl show has been produced and directed by Jim Rooney. Associate director, Jim Marcioni. Later on this evening, the Sooners of Oklahoma take on the Cornhuskers of Nebraska at the Orange Bowl. Right now, stay tuned as Michigan meets USC in the 1979 Rose Bowl right here on NBC.
NBC Sports presents the College Bowl season, featuring the best in college football postseason action. Today from Pasadena, California, Michigan versus USC in the 1979 Rose Bowl. The Rose Bowl is brought to you by Chrysler Plymouth. By Budweiser, the king of beers. When you say Budweiser, you've said it all. By Goodyear, developers of such tire innovations as the new all-season Tiempo radio. And by IBM, helping put information to work for people.
And what a gorgeous first day of 1979 here in Pasadena, California. You're looking in the Arroyo Canyon. In the background, the famed San Gabriel Mountains. Just a perfect day for football. Temperature is 75 degrees. A slight breeze will be blowing from the right goal to the left. Ideal. Now we're moving into the famed Rose Bowl Stadium. 106,000 fans jammed in here. They could have sold nearly 200,000 tickets for this game. The field will be lightning fast and in perfect condition.
All the Bees and Blues faithful join together now in a rousing chorus.
And now the Grand Marshal, Lay Leishman, a human interest story. 40 years ago, he was the tournament director of the Pasadena Rose Bowl festivities, and he's been honored 40 years later, and deservedly so. And here is the Queen, Catherine Mary Gilmore. And with Lay Leishman was Arthur Welsh, who is the tournament president this year. Lay Leishman, you'll meet later. He'll be down at the 50-yard line for the toss of the coin. The Queen and her court. Hi, everybody. Kurt Gowdy with John Brody, O.J. Simpson, and a very happy New Year to you. This is the 65th Rose Bowl game. It's one of the more intriguing matchups we've ever had. Each team has lost only one game. And, of course, there'll be a national debate. Alabama was leading Penn State. If Alabama wins and USC wins there, many will claim that it's USC to be number one because they defeated Alabama earlier in the year. And if Michigan wins, Bo Schembechler says, we beat a great team, we should be number one. Well, we'll be deciding that, and the fans later on. First of all, let's talk to John Brody. Every time Michigan's come here, John, they have moved into the Rose Bowl as the underdog. Not this this year, they are the underdog and not the favorite.
Well, I don't know how much these motivational factors really apply to the game itself. I know that Michigan came out here with their game face on. Bo Schembechler has done things a bit differently this year. They've only hit about three times in practice. They are definitely ready. I think you're going to see a great ball game. I give Michigan its best chance ever.
OJ, USC's had a lot of great teams. You played on some. How good is this current crop?
Well, I think it's as good as any recent team SC's had. They have an excellent offense. They have no weaknesses on offense. On defense, they've had a few injuries. They got some young guys playing there. But I think they're ready. I think Paul McDonald ready. And I think Paul McDonald, the quarterback, is going to be the key in this game.
If USC wins, would you say that they should be the mythical national champ?
Well, you know, at the end of every season, you see the top two teams, and you wish you could get them in a bowl game. Well, fortunately, this year, it may be Alabama SC. They have played earlier in the year. SC won that game decisively. They've had a tough schedule. They played five bowl teams, plus Michigan State, the co-champ in the Big Ten. They've won all those games. And if they win big here today, if I had a vote, they'd get mine. But they get that anyway.
Well, Johnny Robinson, the USC coach, was asked earlier about this situation by Brian Gumbel.
Simple question. If Penn State loses and you win, should you be national champion?
You're not speaking to a very objective guy, but I think we should be considered. I mean, in all honesty, nobody knows who should be and who shouldn't be. I think the only thing that would concern us if we're not considered. If Alabama and ourselves come down to the choice, if your choice is between the two, you ought to at least consider that the two teams played and one of them won.
Consider
it. Yes.
Heavily.
I hope so. I hope we win this game.
Bo Schembechler has never won here. He's had the best coaching record in college football the last 10 years. He's left frustrated every year. What does he have to do to win here today?
I think you're going to see Michigan do things that they haven't done as much of in the past. I think Rick Leach has to have a big day. I think he's capable of having one. People have said, can he play pro football? I think he can. I think he's a great all-around athlete. He knows what he's facing. I think he's going to put it up early, and I think he'll have some success.
In other words, you're looking for Michigan to be more wide open than they have.
It's against Bo Schembechler's viewpoint, but I do think he's going to have a go at it early.
And how about the USC side?
Well, I know John Robinson is concerned. I am. All the talk about who's going to be the number one team, the vote for number one. Hey, SC has to be concerned with Michigan. Michigan's coming in as an underdog, and when you have a great team with the tradition of Michigan coming in as an underdog, hey, you got to look out. I think they're going to be ready. They had a tough schedule in the Big Ten. They were co-champs with Michigan State. They had to play all types of teams, and I think they're the best prepared Michigan team I've seen coming in.
We've had some stirring games here in recent years, these Rose Bowl Classic, and this one may be one of the best. And right now, we're going down to the Rose Bowl field and the playing of our national anthem.
I invite you now to honor America by standing and joining Professor Cavender and the University of Michigan Marching Band in our national anthem.
USC are getting ready for their entrance, and we'll be right back to the 1979 Rose Bowl game. High up here in the rim of the Rose Bowl, and to a lot of you out there across the nation watching, you never get a real good close-up look at these players. We've met them personally, and they're really an outstanding group of college youngsters. So let's meet some of the standouts of today's game. And now let's meet the Wolverines of the University of Michigan. This helmet stands for one of the finest college football programs year after year in America. Here are the co-captains who led the Wolverines to 10 wins and one loss.
Hi, I'm co-captain Jerry Meter. I'm an outside linebacker from Bloomfield Hills, Michigan. My major is physical education.
Hi, I'm co-captain Russell Davis. I play fullback. I'm from Woodbridge, Virginia. My major is parks and recreation. And now I'd like to introduce my roommate and buddy, Harlan Huckabee. Here, Huck, catch.
Thanks, Russ. Hi, I'm Harlan Huckabee, tailback from Detroit, Michigan. My major is labor relations.
Michigan always boasts a powerful running game. Here are the men of the offensive line who open the way.
I'm Gene Johnson, tight end for Flint, Michigan. My major is education.
Hi, Bill Dufek, offensive tackle from East Grand Rapids. My major is physical education.
Greg Burnick, offensive right guard, Detroit, Michigan, Ed Major.
Hi, I'm Steve Nauta, offensive center. Hometown is Norristown, Pennsylvania. Bachelor's degree in literature, science, and arts.
Hi, I'm John Giesler, offensive tackle from Woodville, Ohio, education major.
And there's no way you can hide an All-American.
Hi, I'm Rick Leach, quarterback from Flint, Michigan. My major is phys ed. And now let me introduce some of my partners from the defense.
Michigan's defense is annually up in the top drawer. Quickness, pursuit, gang tackling is their hallmark.
Hi, I'm Dale Kites, defensive tackle from Columbus, Ohio. My major is business.
My name is Curtis Greer. I play defensive tackle. I'm from Detroit, Michigan. My major is journalism.
Hello, my name is Thomas C. Bryan. I play outside linebacker from Detroit, Michigan, and my major is pre-law.
Hi, my name is Mark Brayman. I play defensive back. I'm from Midland, Michigan. My major is business and administration.
Those seniors will be playing their last game for the Big Ten champs. Now let's meet some of the members of the University of Southern California Trojans, the Pac-10 conference champion. The campus of USC, the administration building, and USC's famous mascot, Tommy Trojan. And meet some of the standouts of the second best defense against the rush in college football.
Hi, my name is Myron Lapka. My position is defensive tackle. My junior year, I'm from Chatsworth, California. My major is public administrations.
Hi, my name is Rich Dimler. I'm a senior from the University of Southern California. I play defensive nose guard. I was born and raised in Bayonne, New Jersey. My major is speech communication.
Hello, my name is Gary Cobb. I'm an outside linebacker. I'm a senior. My hometown is Stamford, Connecticut, and I'm a major in sociology.
Hi, my name is Dennis Johnson. I play inside linebacker. I'm a junior. My hometown is Flint, Michigan. Major speech communications.
Southern Cal has always been famed for its running game, and here are some of the men up front who make it go.
Hello, Kansas City. I'm Brad Buddy. I'm an offensive guard for the Trojans. I'm a junior, and I'm a pre-med major.
Hello. My name is Ray Peters. I'm a center. I'm a senior here at USC. I'm from Tahunga, California. I'm a physical education major.
Hi, my name is Pat Howell. I'm offensive guard. I'm a senior. My hometown is Fresno, California. And as you know, I'm a dentistry major.
Hi there. My name's Otis Page, 6'5", 290. I'm an offensive tackle, but I'll be unemployed after the Rose Bowl.
The Trojans throw the ball to talented big play receivers.
Hi. Calvin Sweeney, wide receiver, senior. I'm from Riverside, California, business administration major.
Hello, my name is Kevin Williams, wide receiver. Sophomore, hometown, Sacramento, California, public administration major.
The starting backfield helped the Trojans average 25 points a game this past season and features an All-American and tailback, Charlie White.
Hi, I'm Paul McDonald, quarterback, junior at USC.
My hometown is Covina, California, and my major is business administration.
Hi, my name is Lynn Kane, fullback. I'm a senior, hometown LA, California. Major, speech communications.
Hi, my name is Charles White. I'm a tailback for University of Southern California. I'm a junior. My hometown is San Fernando. My major is speech and communication. And that was just some of our football team, and hopefully we're going to go out and try to win this game today.
And as we look down to the Rose Bowl field, we're waiting for the University of Michigan. They're gathering in the runway. They have about 10 or 12,000 fans here. They'll explode when they come out. They are the co-champs of the Big Ten. Michigan State lost only one game, but Michigan State was ineligible in postseason play.
Kurt, when you look at Michigan, you get the feeling that they're ready. There's not a lot of mis-emotion. I've seen teams jump up and down. I'm not sure all that fanfare helps. They just look ready to me.
They are the underdog today, a slight underdog. As we said, they've always been the favorites here. So, psychologically, they may have a slight break. Here they are, the Michigan Wolverines. And across the way, the Southern Cal Trojans are gathering. OJ, there they are.
Yeah, they look like they're ready. You know, I want to say something about Michigan. You know, I have a younger sister who was trying to pick a college, and I said, if you don't go to SC, go to Michigan, because I played with a lot of Michigan players. When you have a Michigan rookie get up on rookie show in professional football, hey, they stand up on that chair tall, and they belt out that Michigan song. They have a lot of pride in that school.
Clay Leishman on your right is going to be the honorary member of the coin toss. 40 years ago, as we told you, he was president here. He's done a lot, not only for the Rose Bowl, but for college football. That's Art Welsh, the current president of the Tournament of Roses, with him. Now you're meeting the captains, Jerry Meter, Russell Davis. Here's the rest.
Gentlemen, my crew working with me today. Ted DiStefano, the back judge. Gil Marksman, the line judge. Don Mason, the umpire. John Wilson. Today, across the point, will be Mr. Leigh Leachman, who is the grand marshal.
We're having some problems with the referee's mic. This is the toss of the coin. In white, the Michigan captain, Jerry Meter, Russell Davis, Lynn Kane, Rick Dimmler are the USC captains. Leigh Leachman tossed the coin. And now the referee will signify what's happened here. USC won the toss, will receive on your left. Michigan will defend on your right, and there's just a slight breeze. We've been out here, this is my 12th Rose Bowl game in a row, and I can't remember a more perfect afternoon. And we've had some beauties here, but this is just ideal. Coach Jim Beckler jumping in with his club, a very intense, emotional coach. There they go. And Michigan will spread out to kick off. They have a great defensive ball club. They allow just 8 points a game average scored on them. So the high-powered USC offense will have their work cut out. Brian Virgil, a junior from Buchanan, Michigan, will be kicking off. Johnny Robinson, 3 years, has won 30 and lost 6 at USC. And the Trojans will be spreading out now and receiving formation. USC beat Michigan here in the 77 Rose Bowl game. They beat them rather handily. They controlled the ball most of the time. Charles White is going to be back as one of the receivers. He's the tailback, dangerous runner. And Raymond Butler, an outside receiver, number 86, as the other. and a crowd of 106,000 warms up, ready to go. And the 65th Rose Bowl game is underway. They kick away from White. It's going out of bounds. And we'll have a re-kick. It went out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. So back they come. Both teams, by the way, as you'd expect with only one loss, are excellent in covering kickoffs and punts.
You may think it's a surprise that Charles White is back for kickoff returns, but he's done that quite a bit this year. Actually, he led the nation in what you call all-purpose running, receiving, kickoff returns. He averaged over 170 yards a game in all-purpose running. Of course, he averaged 146 yards a game just rushing.
He may not get a chance to look at a kickoff. They don't want him to have the ball. So Brian Virgil again tees it up. And I would imagine again he'll try and kick it to Butler. Here we go. He squibs this one. Touched by one of the short men, picked up, and it's down on the 17-yard line, and that's not very good field position for USC. Ball was being handled around by Mike McDonald. Here is the backfield for USC. McDonald, the quarterback, Kane, the fullback, White, the tailback.
Of course, White is a big man. He's the guy that led him all year this year, but Paul McDonald, he's the guy to watch. If he's hot, SC could be tough.
All right, let's watch this first play from scrimmage. They run the famed power eye. They're on their 17, first down. They're putting Williams in motion, setting it up as a slot, and back he goes again. Now back again. And there's a flag down, and charging offside was number 78, Otis Page. Ron Simpkins made the pass. They had so many men in motion, the same man going so many ways. They had Otis Page confused as he broke offside. It's against USC, a glaring offside. Let's take a look at the receiving core of the University of Southern California. Hunter is the tight end. Cal Sweeney, the split end. The flanker is little Kevin Williams.
They call Kevin Williams the bug. Now, he's an interesting story. He made all Pac-10, but he only caught 17 passes. He only weighs 155 pounds. He didn't do it by blocking, but he did it because he caught 10 touchdowns.
Van Horn, Buddy, Peters, Howell, and Page are up front. STSG means strong side. WTWG means weak side tackle and guard. Slot formation. First down, 15. Look at Michigan. Boy, they're in there. Michigan had Curtis Greer, the defensive right tackle. Let's take a look at the Michigan defense hitting Charlie White. They've changed their lineup. Turgovac did not start. Godfrey and Greer are the tackles, and Kites is now at center.
Kurt, you'll notice also they're playing an even defense right now. They've got them lined up as if they've got a nose guard. Dale Kites has to have a big day on Ray Peters for Michigan to do well. But they're playing an even defense right now and stuffed them on the first play.
They have a second down, 19 USC, from their 8-yard line. The pitch is to White, and White, not much. Met at the line of scrimmage. We told you the hallmark of Michigan is pursuit, quickness, and gang tackling. There are the linebackers.
Jerry Meter's the co-captain, but Ron Simpkins is the man they try to keep all offensive people off. They like to leave him alone, see if he can't bring down the ball carrier. He's had a great year. He's a real All-American. He should have a big day.
Third down. 19 to go. Slot right, USC. They're in a hole early in this game. That's Kane, number 21. Very quick starting fullback, Lynn Kane. And he's hit by Andy Canavino, number 41, the inside. Look at Michigan. They're fired up. They've held him. And now Marty King will come in the punt for the Trojans. And he'll be standing in his end zone when he receives the snap. Mike Jolly is the safety man. Good kick. Tremendous bounce for USC. And that ball is dead on the 28-yard line of Michigan. Jolly let it roll. So from the line of scrimmage. There's the kicker, Marty King. The backfield for Michigan, All-American Rick Leach at quarterback. Davis is the fullback. Huckabee is the tailback.
And both of those running backs have run for over 2,500 yards in their three-year career.
Well, that was a 64-yard kick by Marty King. No score early. First down, Clayton the flanker in motion. They run the option series. Huckabee the tailback is hauled down to the 29-yard line by Dennis Johnson, the strong side inside linebacker. The receivers, the tight end is Gene Johnson. Rodney Feaster, Ralph Clayton are the outside men.
Be a perfect day for Rodney Feaster to have a big one.
Second down, nine. They put Roosevelt Smith in at tailback. Dufek, Bartnick, Nada, Power, Geisler up front for Michigan. Second down and nine. Fake play action pass. Leach fires over the head. Intercepted by the Trojans. Intercepted there by Lott. Lott back in the Michigan territory and carries the ball down just short of the Michigan 15. Ron Lott, the Rover, defensive back.
Here we have man in motion. However, it's just a simple little two-man pattern. Fake to the running back coming through. No backs out in the pattern. Both wide receivers trying to get a piece of it. Ralph Clayton jumps high. Cannot get the ball. Picked off by Ron Lott. SC's got in great field position on the 16-yard line. It looked like a pre-planned play. He had about six red shirts in front of him just as he caught it.
I tell you, John, that's good for SC. It could hurt Michigan not completing passes earlier.
A 34-yard return of that interception by Lott. Charlie White slips through a hole, and he goes to the 12-yard line. White rushed for 1 mile this year, 1,760 yards. There are the defensive backs of Michigan, Bell, Jolly, Brayman, and Harden.
Jolly knows he's got his hands full today. He'll be outside on a corner on Kevin Williams most of the day.
Rock. Shannon is in now, tied in. Number 80. There he is in motion. Cut back. White slips inside the 10 to the 9-yard line, Charlie White. Ron Simpkins, who leads Michigan in tackles, in fact, the all-time tackling record, 174 for the season, made that last hit on Charlie White.
If you notice, SC has been trying to establish an off-tackle and outside running game. I think they may be a little concerned about running up the middle. Ray Peters, the guy who's starting at center for USC, is the sixth string center. They had an incredible string of bad luck with their center. Take a look at Peters there. He played nose guard up to this year, and they moved him to center when they lost everyone.
Third down and three for the Trojans. McDonald wants to throw, and he's got it for a touchdown. He hit his receiver in the end zone for the touchdown.
Kobe Brenner.
Kobe Brenner, where'd he come from? He's listed as about a four-stringer.
Juice just said he wasn't in his game plan.
Kobe Brenner caught that ball.
We got him hot.
Okay, Paul McDonald, little fakey in there. Lynn Cain, he comes off. Actually, it was excellent defensive coverage. You see, he's getting pretty good pressure. Puts the ball the only place it can be thrown. And Kobe Brenner comes up with six.
He is a sophomore. He's not even listed in the first three deep. The kick is up by Frank George. The kick is good, and USC has jumped out in front, and that's what Michigan was trying to avoid. Timeout with a score. The Trojans 7, the Wolverines nothing. We're going to have a rerun now, the touchdown.
Okay, McDonald has been their leader. Juice, you hit it on the head. He's the guy that has to have a big day. All his receivers look covered. Perfect touch on the ball over the top of the defenders into the arms of Brenner, and they take the lead.
John, I want to ask you, is a quarterback like a pitcher? I mean, Leach came out. They know he has to pass. His first pass is an interception. Can he forget that?
I think certain guys can. Others can't. I think Rick Leach will come back firing. I don't think he's the type of guy with the makeup. I don't think it'll bother.
Kicking off now will be Frank Jordan. Jackson and Clayton are deep. Jackson has it. And he downs it for the touchback. So it'll be Michigan's ball, first down on their own 20. And Michigan will be facing a defense that was second in the nation against the rush. Myron Lapka, Rich Dimmler, Dennis Edwards, three down linemen.
Keep an eye on Dennis Edwards. He has work cut out for him. He's a freshman. He's only starting because Ty Sperling was hurt in the last game against Hawaii for SC.
First down, Michigan, on their 20. Huckabee and Russell Davis, running back. And bursting through over the 25 to the 26-yard line is Russell Davis from Woodbridge, Virginia, who averaged 4.5 yards a carry. He was injured this year with an ankle. Huckabee's had a knee. They've had all kinds of injury problems in their backfield. Larry McGrew made the hit, and he's in the linebacking corps for USC.
I see another freshman in that lineup, Juice.
Well, Ricky Gray's a starter. He's been doing it for him all year long.
Second down, four. Clayton is in motion. Here's the option. Leach pitches out. Huckabee fumbles the ball and may have it again. He does. The pitch to Harlan Huckabee off the option, the tailback, and they were fortunate recovering there deep in their own territory.
And, Kurt, you always wonder how they're going to defense the option play. Sometimes they'll take their option to crash down the line, hit the quarterback before he can get anything started. Other times you'll see them pursue from the inside out. It looks like SC's plan is to go from the inside out, let Leach get down the line a bit, hope he cuts up, and stuff him when he does.
And we gave you the secondary, Lavender, Brazil in the corners, blots the rover, and Dennis missed the safety. Third down, seven for Michigan. Leach in a straight drop back, out they spread. He's firing deep, he's got Clayton open, and it's over his head. Ralph Clayton was out there in the open. He's averaged 22 yards a catch this year and the leading receiver with 23 receptions.
You can see why they throw a lot of play action passes. That was typical of their style. Clayton gets down on the defender very fast. Larry Brazil trying to handle him. However, he just kind of dissects that double zone. Gets down to where he is pretty well open. Leach would like to have that ball back.
John, I think it was a little mix-up back there. It looked like SC was playing zone, and they had a little mix-up at who had the deep outside coverage.
Whenever a man's that open, it always looks that way.
Punt formation. Greg Wilner's averaged 40 yards a kick. Butler is back, wide receiver. A low kick. Bounces right into him. He should get a return out of that, and he fell down. Anytime you get that low kick to you, you have a chance for a good return. Michael Petch was down there covering the punt for Michigan. When we return, the Trojans have the ball, and they're in the lead with 9:11 to go in the first period, 7-0. From high above Pasadena, California, the Goodyear blimp Columbia is bringing us these spectacular aerial views of the Rose Bowl, which is spectacular itself. First down, USC on their own 37. They're out in front, 7-0. They have a new receiver in, Dan Garcia, number 26, replacing Calvin Sweeney. Paul McDonald, this is the power eye. He's going to throw. He's a left-hander out to White. White's at the 40. They like to get him out there on a flare pass and let him go to work one-on-one on somebody. Andy Canavino and Gene Bell made the stop.
Kurt, actually, that looked like a little quick screen there. They had a big tackle getting out there with them, and I think they were trying to throw a little quick screen out there.
We want you to watch the handoffs sometimes. The quarterback, McDonald, will retreat deep in the USC backfield and hand it off to the tailback, much deeper than any other college team. There's a reason for that. No Jay Simpson, who used to take many of those handoffs. There it is, right there. That's White coming through. Boy, he's got more. He's got a first down as he's into Michigan territory. Why the deep handoff to the tailback, O.J.?
Well, SC is philosophy is what they call option running. The offensive line will block solid throughout the line. If you line up deep, you get the ball deep, you can see where the holes are. Sometimes the hole may be on the other side of the line of scrimmage, and if you're too close, you can't see it. But if you're deep enough, you can see the whole line, and you can pick your hole.
And it's nice to have an offensive tackle like Otis Page to create one.
Yeah, it certainly helps.
First down. Southern Cal and the Michigan 48. Southern Cal's ahead 7-0. 8 minutes to play in the first period. That time they trip up Lynn Kane. Lynn Kane, has been a very important cog in this USC team. He came here as a tailback. They converted him to fullback. He's the all-time leading rushing fullback with 893 yards. An excellent blocker, very quick off the mark.
Yeah, when Lynn first came here, they thought he was going to be the next great SC tailback. He was player of the year in junior college ball here. He had some problems with his legs with injuries. They moved him to fullback, and he's done an excellent job for the school.
Second down, 9. They're in a slot formation. The left-hander, McDonald. He's trapped. They get to him. They knock him down back at his 45-yard line. And that's Chris Godfrey, who is playing left tackle, number 90, who got to him.
And, Kurt, he did it. He did it the hard way, because up front, those three down linemen, the two guards in the center, did their job. Ray Peters, we've been looking at. He's got to do a good job on the nose, man. Kites is coming after him. He gets a little help from his left tackle. And he gets just enough help, because there was very little penetration up front. Godfrey did it all on his own.
Yeah, Ray Peters did an excellent job. The guard, buddy, should have went out and helped Otis Page that time.
Third and 15. McDonald to White. White just short of the 50-yard line. They thought Michigan would be looking for the pass, so they tried the quick opener up the middle. Michigan has stopped them. Godfrey again on the tackle. And now Marty King comes in to punt. And his first punt of 64 yards helped set up the first score of the game. Because in Michigan territory, USC intercepted a pass. Michael Jolly is back as a safety man. Marty King kicks it right to him on the hop. Taken on the 15 by Jolly. Look at that coverage. 5. Cardinal and gold. Trojans down there to smother him. And it'll be Michigan's ball, first down, when we return to the Rose Bowl with a score 7-0 USC. There's been a big roar here in the Rose Bowl. They just announced the final score. Alabama knocking off Penn State 14-7. Penn State's first loss of the year. And now a real national debate is going to go on. If USC wins here, they defeated Alabama at Birmingham. Will they be number one? What do you think about it, OJ?
Well, you heard the cheer that went up when they heard the score here in the stadium. I think there's a lot of SC people, including myself, who feels that SC, if they can pull this game off, should be the national champion. They beat Alabama in Alabama, which is certainly tough for any team.
Of course, if Michigan wins, they think they could have it. Look at that hole open. That was Ricky Gray who made the tackle. And carrying the ball was Russell Davis on the quick opener. John, what do you think about it all?
I think Michigan's concerned with winning this football game, and they'd have to leapfrog an awful lot of people. And I think USC better be concerned with winning this football game, because right now is all that matters, and all that other stuff is up to other people's vote. They do their part, they can be satisfied.
That'll all be settled later. On the 24-yard line of Michigan, the Wolverines have a second down and 2. Ralph Clayton going out of motion. Leach keeps the ball. Now pitches to Huckabee. Huckabee has a first down on the option play. Huckabee averaged 5.3 yards this year. Gained 713 for the year and missed 3 games with a bad knee.
I'm a little surprised that Leach is running the option to the right. He's left-handed. He runs well to the left. And as we said before, the defensive end for USC on that side is Dennis Edwards. He's a freshman, and he hasn't played all year. And I thought they would test him a little more than what they're doing right now.
5:47 left in the first period. USC leading 7-0. Alan Mitchell is in the game as a wide receiver, number 30, replacing Feaster. Out of motion is Clayton. Leach to the tailback. Huckabee, that was a deep handoff. Huckabee trying the middle, got to his 34. Ran into the freshman Ricky Gray and Dennis Johnson, the two inside linebackers.
And Michigan knows if they're going to be in the game, have a good chance to win, they've got to win at the line of scrimmage. That time, Greg Bartnick, Steve Nauta, John Powers, the three of them up front did their job.
They have two tight ends for Michigan. Gene Johnson, 88. Doug Marsh, 80. A little more blocking power. Look at those impressive statistics. He holds a string of records now at the University of Michigan. Rick Leach keeps the ball. Throws it out to Huckabee. Huckabee slammed out of bounds on the 42-yard line, but has another first down. Driven out by Johnson and Dennis Smith.
All right, 3 years ago, you might have seen Rick Leach fire that ball out to his running back. This time, just perfect touch. He's got a pretty good rush on him. Lays the ball up just where Huckabee needs it. They pick up a first down, and they're on the march.
And here's Huckabee. Huckabee is that speed man. If they have a breakaway man, he's the man here. I think they got to do this more today. They got to throw little swing passes. I don't think Leach should get impatient and try to throw downfield. Their running game thus far has been going real well for them.
They're on their 41 with the first down. Alan Mitchell in motion. Keeper Leach, reverse pivot, comes over the 45 to the 47. They're opening holes now. Leach stopped by Ricky Gray and Gary Cobb.
This is something you can't teach. He's got a few options, but just as he spins, he's got to make a move on Dennis Johnson, who absolutely got annihilated out of the hole. He took the proper break, and he's got it to where they need three for a first.
They're on their 47 with a second and four. The clock moving. Four and a half to play in the first period. USC out in front, 7-0. They scored with 10:47 to go in the first period. That's Russell Davis, the fullback. Davis is hit by Dennis Edwards, a freshman, and Rich Dimler, the nose guard. Marv Goh, the assistant coach at USC, says he is the toughest nose guard they ever had there.
And if Marv Goh said that, he's got to be some sort of cat.
Tell you, Marv Goh recruited me. They used to call him my daddy when I was at SC, made sure I went to class. But Marv Goh has coached 11 All-Americans, and if he said that about Dimler, Dimler must be a tough kid.
The tight ends are bringing the plays in. Ralph Clayton's back in now. Mitchell's out. Third down and a yard to go for Michigan on the 50-yard line. They have marched upfield here on this drive. Uh-oh. They jump. That was John Geisler. Geisler, 68. USC came, got back, and then Geisler moved, and right now he's feeling...
very inopportune time dejected for him to jump.
Yeah, I tell you, that's a good move for SC because Michigan is moving the ball pretty well against them, and I think Leach will have to throw on this play. I think SC want Leach to throw the football.
Well, they may before he throws it.
Well, at this point in the game, I think they'd like to see him put it up in the air. He's only thrown it downfield really once, and that's what's got him in trouble.
It's not the style of Michigan. They generally don't come out firing that ball all over, as you say. They've only thrown an average of about 16, 17 passes a game. But I think you're going to see a lot more of it.
They have a third and six now instead of a third and one. They have Roosevelt Smith in. They have a blitz on. And hey, Gary, they had everybody but the kitchen sink coming that time.
And they disguised it very well because they waited till Leach could not get into an audible. They didn't have anybody to pick up the blitzing linebacker coming right up the middle. Leach had nowhere to go. You can see he's barely the first guy back there.
You're going to see number 49, Dennis Smith, the safety, come flying in there. They had a safety blitz on, and they just couldn't pick up all the men.
Looked like they had a meeting back there. That's what it looks like from Leach's viewpoint. Not too good.
Punt formation. Greg Wilner will do the kicking. Raymond Butler is a safety man. Ball is bouncing to the USC 31-yard line where the Trojans have it. I want to remind you, right after the Rose Bowl game, we'll switch you to the Orange Bowl in Miami. Nebraska, the official Big 8 champs, 9-2 against Oklahoma, 10-1. These are two really potent offensive clubs. You'll see Billy Sims, the Heisman Trophy winner. What do you think of Billy Sims, O.J.? You watched him on TV this year.
Well, with all due respect to my man Charles White, I thought Billy Sims was the finest runner I've seen in college ball this year. He can do it all. He's an exciting runner. He's a little bigger than Charles, and I thought he should have won the Heisman Trophy.
Well, you're an honest man. First down, USC on their 31. Charles White. White is cut down on the 34-yard line of USC. You keep watching Michigan, and you notice how quick they are, how quickly they move laterally.
Well, they better, because that number 12 can scoot.
You know his biggest thrill, and he's had a lot of them, he now has gained more yards than any running back in the history of the Pac-10 conference.
Big deal.
Big deal. Sorry to say so. He's got another year to go, too, O.J.
He's tough.
Well, I'll tell you about his big thrill, though. McDonald's getting a car. Now he's wrapped up by Tom Sebring. the outside linebacker, 91, who chased him down.
And give the secondary credit. They're the ones that kept any receiver from coming open. McDonald had all the time he needed under normal circumstance to get the pass off. Sebrun got there late from his outside backer position. You can see as McDonald goes back, he's looking to Calvin Sweeney. He's covered by Jolly. He has nowhere to go with the ball, and Sebrun comes up from behind.
They have a third and 14. Godfrey has just limped off for Michigan, and Dale Kites has gone in to replace him. A tackle. Third down, 14. USC under 27. They're ahead, 7-0. Minute and a half to go in the first period. They're spread out all over now as McDonald fades. There's a pass way over the head of Sweeney, Calvin Sweeney. He missed him. Let's take a look at Sweeney as we isolate on him.
Mentioned early that Jolly has got his work cut out covering Sweeney and Kevin Williams. This time gets a little help with a little hit. As he makes his turn, he was open. The ball came just a little late, a little bit high, and it isn't too nice if you don't come down with the ball.
Well, even if he would have caught it, he wouldn't have had the first down. It's sort of surprising that he didn't run another 2 yards for the first down yardage. He averages over 20 yards a catch during the season.
Mighty King is rushed. Jolly has a flag down. They ran into King. Let's see what they call this. You can incidentally run into a kicker in college football, and they won't call it. It's got to be flagrant roughing. And they dropped the flag back there on the punt. It was a low punt. Both clubs are putting pressure on the punters now. And they're talking with Michigan. That's Jerry Meter, number 46, the captain. Roughing the kicker.
Well, we'll see somebody come out of the right side of that screen in just a second. Obviously, it looked as if he was blocked into him, but there were two or three fellas all made contact. And
I think he got a job out at the studios, you know, maybe Universal. He did a good job there.
They needed 14 yards. The extra yard, there's a good hit on Charles White by Dale Kites. They got the 15-yard penalty. Roughing the kicker in college football is not an automatic first down.
That was a perfect example of some of the problems you might have when you have a six-string center playing for you. Kites just shot the gap in there, and he really shouldn't have that much penetration. He made an excellent play.
We're in the last minute of the first period of the Rose Bowl game, but USC out in front, 7-0. We've had some great charges by the defensive linemen, both teams. White again, he's hit and pulled down on his 41-yard line. Bo Schembechler said, O.J., it's phenomenal how they'll let a back carry the ball 30 times a game. Wade White, how many? You averaged over 35 times a game, didn't you?
Yeah, about 38. I think, one, you run so much in practice. You run about twice that amount of time in practice. But the big thing is, SC will always have a big, strong, sturdy offensive line, and I think a back can carry the ball quite a bit if he has big, strong linemen, because defensive linemen are not tackling them, and if they're tackling them, your offensive line is not doing the job.
Third down, 11. Trojans operating out of the eye. Oh, he's hit. The ball's loose. Michigan has it. Tom Sebrun, 91 in there. Smacked into it. Dale Kites recovered the fumble. And Michigan has the ball. They hit him before his hand started forward.
And that is the worst lick a quarterback can take. When he gets a hit from his blind side, and Paul McDonald's blind side is his right since he's left-handed. He was looking down to the short side of the field, had no idea that Sebrun was on his way, and the lights went out.
That's a charged-up ball club.
Yeah, they are. SC's offense hasn't done much today. I saw that Paul was injured. It seemed to be injured right there, and if he goes out, SC could be in a lot of trouble.
That 91 Sebrun has really been penetrating.
He's got a key because he's getting loose. Nobody seems to be in his way. They've got to find a way to get it.
And we've come to the end of the first period with a score, USC 7 and Michigan nothing. We'll return to the Rose Bowl in just a moment. Right now, we pause for these messages from your local station.
Okay, this is how the turnover occurred. Gives Michigan the same kind of break SC had early in the ball game. McDonald is back, and you can see he barely gets set up before Sebrun lowers the boom on him, and the ball takes a hike. Michigan's got it on a 23.
First scoring opportunity for Michigan. A on the SC 23. Out of the eye, Leach keeps. And lunges forward to the 20-yard line. Ricky Gray, the weak side linebacker, the freshman from Tucson, Arizona, made the stop on him. This is the magic quarter for USC. Get this. This year, in the second quarter, they scored 128 points. Their opponent scored six. The magic quarter for Michigan is the third period, when they scored 90 points to just seven for the opponent. So we'll see how USC fares in the second period against the fired-up Michigan ball club.
They're going to need a lot of magic, it looks like, right now.
Second down, eight. Clayton going in motion. Leach on the keeper. Flares it out. He's got him out there, and he dropped the ball. Huckleby could have gone for the first down.
He could have. He might have gone all the way downtown. There was nobody in the area.
And that's the second time they ran that play, and that the second time nobody was near him. They ran it earlier in the first quarter. Huckleby picked up a first down, and I think he would have scored there.
Well, Juice, if you have watched Michigan play over the years, they've thrown very few passes to their running backs. I'm sure that SC knows that. However, Rick Leach has turned the tempo around a bit. He's thrown to his backs. He's had a few wide receivers open. It's just a matter of time if he keeps pumping.
They have a third and eight. Huckleby's caught one pass of this game. He had received only five all year. Third down, eight. And they stop at the 18-yard line. Russell Davis. They're trying to get a trap and a quick opener there. But Rich Dimmler, the nose guard, 255, said, uh-uh. So let's see what they do now. They have a fourth down and six. They're at the 18-yard line of USC. And B.J. Dickey, sophomore, will hold. And doing the kicking will be Greg Wilder. He had 6 out of 12 this year. This will be a 36-yard attempt. The kick is up, and the kick is good. Michigan is on the board. 36-yard field goal with 13:37 to go in the first half. They'll be lining up for the kickoff, and we'll be back at the Rose Bowl. That's Saturday, January 20th, for the 11th annual Vitalis U.S. Olympic Track Meet. Kicking off, Brian Virgil for Michigan, Charles White, Raymond Butler deep for USC. And this one is handled by Butler. The 20 breaks away. He's at the 30, 35, 40, 45, still going, and is down in Michigan territory at the Michigan 49. Gerald Diggs got him, number 29, a junior from Chicago.
Marcus Allen, number 33, was out front, made two or three blocks. He did just about all a man leading the ball carrier can do.
You're going to hear a lot about Marcus Allen in the years to come. He's a top player from San Diego, and he may be the big tailback after Charles White leaves SC. But you see him, he broke back to his left, picked up some blockings, and there's Marcus Allen hustling for him in front of him. He tried to cut back there, just couldn't quite make it.
41-yard return. McDonald's handoff deep to White. White's knocked down. Now he's trying to get that picket line going. He's really in trouble now. They've got him contained and finally haul him out. They take him out on his own 40-yard line. Mike Jolly, the halfback.
All right, Juice, what do you do when the doors are all shut?
Well, being a competitor, Charles White's a competitor. Sometimes they say the best thing to do is run straight ahead and try. Just try to minimize the yards you lose. But a competitor, hey, he's going to fight. He's going to run. He's going to hustle. He's going to go back. Hopefully, he pick up a picket line. He didn't pick up the picket line. He knows he's in trouble now, and the only thing you can do is run. I mean, you run as fast as you can and try to turn up.
There were no windows in that log cabin.
None. The problem here is they're getting too much penetration on SC.
Second down, 21 to go. Lynn Kane, quick opener. He's to his 47-yard line. Andy Canavino stopped him, a sophomore and inside linebacker.
Well, you know, Kurt, you know Bo Schembechler has told his team about SC's second quarter statistics. And I'm sure they've thought a lot about it coming in here, that let's contain SC in the second quarter, and we may have some kind of psychological advantage over them. And thus far, they're doing a good job of it.
Knowing it is one thing, handling is another.
Yeah. Well, they're doing a good job of it now, John.
They have a third down, 15. From their own 46, USC, they're leading 7-3. Early in the second period, McDonald to White. White, they're right on him. White struggling for yardage today. He's averaged nearly 150 yards a game. Mike Turgovac drove him out of bounds. And Mike White's had about 15 yards and 11 carries. Johnny Robinson is talking to him, the coach. White was a little upset. And it's punt formation now as Michigan looks very strong on defense.
Well, I think the thing with White now, he's geared up, he's ready to go, and he's just not getting any room to run in. He's getting a little frustrated. He got up and had a few words to say that time.
Marty King will punt it. Mike Jolly fields it on his 13, 15, and is whammed into on his 18, 17-yard line.
This is a case where it was a low punt. When Jolly gets it, however, he doesn't have enough of his pals around. He's got to take Duck, get all he can, but they're all red shirts.
It'll be Michigan's ball when we return with a score. USC 7 and Michigan 3. Pacific Coast teams have won 8 of the last 9 Rose Bowl games. Ohio State, the only team to win in that stretch in 74, beating USC 42-21. And does the Big Ten want this one today? Michigan on their 17 with a first down. Leach, Davis, Huckabee. It goes plate out in motion. Leach keeps the ball, running the option. Stopped on the 19-yard line, a 2-yard gain. He's a remarkable athlete. Dennis Johnson, the junior, helping on the tackle.
All right, that's true, but it looks like SC would like to have Rick Leach run because they haven't put a lot of pressure on him to pitch the ball out. They're waiting for him to turn up where they can make the play. It's almost like a quarterback sack when you get a piece of that quarterback.
Yeah, I'm surprised. Leach is a pretty smart runner, too. He knows when to get down on the ground, you know.
He is the only quarterback to score or pass for over 200 points and rush for over 200 points in his career, in the history of college football. He's going to do a straight drop back. He's hit. He gets away. He's down on the 6-yard line. And in on him was number 96, Myron Lapka from Chatsworth, California, the junior left tackle who had a tremendous charge off the ball.
Well, generally, Rick Leach gets a lot of time to throw. This is another play-action pass. Lapka wasn't buying any of it. He gets by Bill Dufek. And really, Leach looked like he had gotten out of the problem, slipped on the turf, and fell down.
Neither one of these quarterbacks have time back there for a cup of coffee and a sandwich today. They're both getting furious pass rushes.
Thus far, it's been a game of the defensive lines.
Third down, 21, Michigan on their 6. Mitchell's out. Hand off to Davis. Davis hit hard at the 9-yard line by the safety, Dennis Smith.
You know, they said that Bo Schembechler believes in the pass now. You'll find out just how much faith they have in the pass when their back is against the wall and they need a lot of yardage. You got to have a lot of faith in it, John.
I don't blame him at this time. I mean, I don't think it's the time to throw the ball. They're very much in the ball game. They know they've waited for their defense to come up with a big play, get them a turnover, and they're just not geared to throw the ball 26, 27 yards.
And they're going over to the sideline. I believe it's Dimmler. Dimmler asked the official blow the whistle so he could go over, and Brad Steelman, nose guard, came in to replace him. This will be a punt formation now. Greg Wilner to do the kicking, and the dangerous returner, Raymond Butler, who you saw just run a kickoff back 41 yards. He's the deep man. They're going after him. He just got it away, but it's a beauty. Butler on his 48 to the 50. Swarmed under on the Michigan 49. And leading that charge downfield was Tony Leone from Flint, Michigan, along with Ben Needham from Groveport, Ohio. All right, we have 10 minutes to play in the first half with a timeout. Trojans 7, Wolverines 3. Final score of the Cotton Bowl, Notre Dame winning 35-34. Joe Montana threw a touchdown pass with no time remaining to win it. And he almost pulled it out here against USC in the fourth period.
You talk about your quarterback prospects. He's got to be as good as any.
Well, thus far, SC is down 3-0 in the second quarter. A little reputation is on the line here.
Two tenacious defenses checking each other. Paul McDonald, a junior, he'll be back next year, brings them up. They're on the Michigan 49. That's Kane whipping through to the 41. Lynn Kane is stopped by Gene Bell, number 42.
And watch this block by Charles White.
I guess when you're not carrying the ball, you must be active.
Blocking behind the runner.
And that is
shows you're into the game.
That's a defensive tackle, Curtis Greer. And there's a little size difference. Once he hit him, he wasn't satisfied. He went after him again.
Shows the man's in the game, huh?
Second down, two. Again, the hole open for Lynn Kane. They're going to him now. They've been checking Charlie White. White has only 13 yards and 11 carries. And now it's Kane.
I'll tell you, Kurt, I've got a question, Juice. They seem to be more effective running right up the gut. Now, SC's personality has been to run wide. You call it student body right, student body left. But they have been effective when they've run up the gut.
Well, I think it's because of Michigan's defense is so quick. We'll get into that after this play.
Kane for the third straight carry. Listen to these figures to show you how ferocious these defenses have been. Total yardage for Michigan in this game, 24 yards, 17 on the ground, 7 passing. USC, 14 passing, minus 4 rushing. Total of 10 yards.
Yeah, one of the problems, if there's a problem with lining up so deep at tailback, is if you play against a quick team, the pursuit can get there by the time you get to the line of scrimmage, and that's what's been happening. Michigan's defense is so quick, they're meeting Charles at the point of attack. So they're hitting him quick, just like this, up the middle.
That's what they're doing now. Lynn Kane, for the fourth time in a row, he's had the ball, he's had room, and he is quick. Simpkins makes the hit on him.
All right, Ron Simpkins has got his work cut out for him. He's got Buddy coming down the line at him, Howell coming down the line. Peters is doing his job in the middle on kites. And Lynn Kane is picking up the yardage.
Lynn Kane is the big ball carrier in this game at 26 yards. He averaged 5 yards a carry, scored 4 touchdowns this season. First down. There's a hole for him. Right. His biggest gain of the day.
The SC hitting them quick up the middle. Forces the defense to play a little tighter, but forces the linebackers to respect Lynn Kane, and then those off-tackle holes begin to open. Charles White hit it quick. He got outside real quick. And this is just right here. It's just all effort, all desire.
I think sending Kane up the middle has really changed things now.
I know this, Charles White likes it when he sees a little daylight. If you get past the point of attack with the ball in your hand, those defensive backs can't do a job on you.
First down, goal to go. Trojans on the Michigan 5. Kane goes to the 3 in a diving thrust. Or Charles White on the diving thrust, hit by Turgovac and Mike Harden. And you notice the tight end, Vic Rakshani. He came back and then peeled into the line to try and lead the blocking. 3-yard line. Second down. 3 to go for a USC touchdown. 7:45 to go. Bo Schembechler is anxious.
You're talking about tough. This is the toughest part of the football field to gain anything on.
White again. And a fumble. It's a big fumble. They say he was over. Doesn't matter what happens after he's above or over the goal line. He had crossed or was over the goal line and scored.
We may have a chance to see it, but if he did fumble the ball when he hit the ground, he definitely was in the end zone.
Well, I'm for SC, but I thought he had lost control of it before he got into the end zone, but hopefully we'll get a chance to see it again. Right after the point after touchdown, we'll take a good look at it, and you will judge for yourself.
Frank Jordan, who has kicked 2 dramatic field goals 2 years ago against UCLA and against Notre Dame this year, will try the point. It is up, and the point is good. Well, USC now builds their lead to 14-3. Now let's take a look at this play at the goal line with Charlie White bucking in.
We'll let them look for themselves.
Thank you.
I can't even see the ball, let alone whether
I can't see the ball. It looked like the ball was behind him, though, John. But all you have to do is break the plane of the end zone, and it counts. I thought he had lost it. See the ball below.
The ball is right there. Now, what you can't tell is whether he was over the plane of the end zone when the ball fell out. And I don't think we should put ourselves in a position of judgment when we're not on that goal line. They're on the goal line.
Well, I'm not on the goal line. I'm for SC, but I thought he fumbled the ball, John. But I'm glad. We must be living right, you know, down here in Southern California, because it's 7 points no matter how you look at it now.
Now, Michigan will have a lot of controversy to say about that.
Boy, Simpkins made a good, he made a good play to get a piece of that ball and get it out of White's hand.
They had a controversial play in an earlier Rose Bowl game. Art Murkowski of Northwestern at the goal line. Many say he fumbled. They called it a touchdown against the University of California.
You know something, Kirk, that things like this often have a way of equalizing themselves out. They'll even out as the game goes on.
Here's the kick coming to Tony Jackson. Jackson up to his 28-yard line. He stopped there.
All right, we're trying to determine clearly whether or not he had the ball in the end zone in possession.
I think he loses it right here. I think the ball is lost immediately right there.
Watch where the ball lands.
It's hard to tell. It certainly dropped on the playing field.
Michigan on their 28 with a first down. Leach to Huckabee. Huckabee to his 35. Hit by Ricky Gray, the inside linebacker. They have their fingers crossed at Huckabee today. You'll see how long he can last. There's Charles White, who just scored the touchdown. One more year for him at USC.
Now, the thing about Huckabee, he is their only legitimate breakaway threat out of the backfield. He was a member of their mile relay team that finished third in the NCAA finals this year, and they won the Big Ten.
Second down, 3. Michigan on their 35, trailing 14-3. Just under 7 to play in the first half. And that was Russell Davis on the option. He was the first man through. He was hit by Gary Cobb, the strong side linebacker from Stamford, Connecticut. Interesting story on Cobb that O.J. was telling us about.
Yeah, Ricky Cobb, you know, his father didn't graduate from high school until he was 25. Yet he has two brothers and a sister who went to college on academic scholarships in the Ivy League, no doubt. And he could have gone to SC on academic scholarship, but he chose the football scholarship.
Great story. Michigan is on their 39. They have Roosevelt Smith now at tailback. Leach is going to pass. He has a man open. He hits him. That's Clayton. Ralph Clayton, the wing back. Caught that ball's out of bounds on the Trojan 40. Dennis Smith, the safety man, knocked him out of bounds.
And when you force the safety man to come all the way over to the outside zone, it's a little bit much to ask of him. Leach runs a little play-action pass, comes out, hits Clayton right in between the two zone defenders. Well-thrown ball.
I tell you what they're doing, John. They're running the receiver down the sideline, and they're running the tailback, Huckabee, out in the flat, forcing the corner to come up to cover Huckabee, and there's a big hole in there before the safety can get over to cover that deep outside.
Michigan on the USC 40 with a first down. Leach to Roosevelt Smith. He's playing on a bad ankle. Rick Dimmler and Ricky Gray made the hit on him to stop him. And we're going to pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network. Kurt Gowdy, John Brody, O.J. Simpson, the Rose Bowl, Pasadena, 5:52 to go in the first half. The Trojans ahead 14-3. Alabama has defeated Penn State today, 14-7. Notre Dame nipped Houston 35-34. Harlan Huckabee back in the game, and he can't get outside for much. He goes down on the 36-yard line of USC. Gary Cobb pursuing him across the field, and the cornerback, Larry Brazil.
Actually, that was a good play. They picked up about 5 yards. Would have been a good first down play. It's the first time they really got outside real quick today. It looked like he was going to get much more yards than he ended up getting.
And they're back in that very untenable position of third down and 7.
And they've sent in Roosevelt Smith, the tailback. Gene Johnson is a tight end. Third down, 7. Leach has the time. His receiver had about 4 men in front of him. Dennis Smith was the man that deflected it and thought he should have caught it.
Well, he's right.
Yeah, I tell you one thing, they had Roosevelt Smith fake over the middle and run into the flat, and he was open for the first down. Roosevelt Smith started in the Rose Bowl last year.
Fourth down, 7. Dennis Smith from Santa Monica, sophomore. This was not supposed to be USC's year. This is a young team. They thought their vintage year might be next season, and they've got most of them back. They've done all right this year. What'll it be next year?
It should be tougher. You know, Otis Page is starting a tackle for him on offense. They lost an All-American, Anthony Munoz, and he'll be back next year, so they should be tougher.
They're going for it. 4th and 7. They're gambling. Leach traveling around. The pass. Not close at the 30-yard line. And the man that hit him was Gary Cobb. Russell Davis was waiting for the ball. Just as he got to him, Cobb belted him from behind.
All right, easy to second guess right now, but I love it. When a team has enough confidence in themselves to go for something, 4th and 7, around midfield, they must have confidence in their defense. They know they've got to get back in the ball game. They're not going to wait for the next half to do it. Leach does his job. Unfortunately, Russell Davis doesn't come down with the ball.
With 4:47 remaining in the first half, the score in the Rose Bowl is USC 14 and Michigan 3. The Bob Hope Desert Classic, Saturday, January 13th, 4 to 6. Sunday, January 14th, 4:30 to 6:30. John Brody and Arnie Palmer will be your hosts. Good luck, John.
Thank you very much. Looking forward to it.
Right now, USC at the 37, their own with a first down. The flare pass, the White. White is dropped.
Now, that play looked like it could have went a long way, but Calvin Sweeney was supposed to be blocking, and he didn't block his man.
And we're still trying to find that definitive shot on the touchdown of Charles White. It looks like from this angle, we could determine it. Oh, and I...
Long before.
I stand corrected.
It's not a touchdown.
Yeah, it is.
It's
long
not a
guard.
Touchdown. The ball dropped out before it got to the goal line. They called it a touchdown, however.
Which makes it a touchdown.
It's a touchdown. But that shot tells it all. That was a 3-yard plunge by Charlie White with 7:32 to go and a half. That's a hard play to call. You remember the 2 fumbles at the tail end of the AFC season last year, Baltimore in Denver against Oakland. Down there, they're all masked. The fumble on the goal line is difficult to call, and it can be very controversial. That ball fell out of his hands before he reached the goal line. Definitely. We have a 3rd down, 9. There's White. White with his speed. He goes down on the 37, and USC will have to punt.
A little surprising, you know, this field is in excellent condition. There's very few games, maybe a high school game or two that played on this field during the course of the year. It's one of the better fields I've ever played on, but we saw a lot of players slipping on it today.
Again, Marty King will boot it, and Michael Jolly will receive it. And Charlie White, I don't believe, has had a tough first half running with the ball as he's had in this game. That's a low kick again. Skips by Jolly, a USC roll. And is dead down there along the 10-yard line.
He may start a trend, Kurt. I haven't seen him kick the ball over about 15 feet off the ground. All of them have been effective.
Very long. He was all packed to 10.
All right, it's Michigan's ball on their own 10 when we return with a score of 14-3 USC. Lighter than air, larger than life, over 192-foot blimp. Blown today, right over the Rose Bowl. Giving you some of these magnificent aerial shots. Time remaining in the first half is 2:59. USC leading 14-3. Their second touchdown will be much discussed for years to come.
I don't know where we got the shot.
Going down is Huckabee. Players seem to be slipping a little bit today.
Yeah, I'm surprised. I think sometimes when you have a real good feel, the field feels fast, and you want to run fast, and sometimes you just outrun yourself.
I was going to ask you, can you just get a little bit too anxious?
Yeah, I think the field is hard. I saw you sort of, it seemed as if he twisted his tweaked his ankle there a little bit, but I think sometimes the fields can be a little too fast, and you try to run a little too fast on it.
Second down, 11. That's Clayton popping into the huddle, 22. Their top pass receiver, Gene Johnson, the tight end's out. So they really have three wide receivers in there now. There is Huckabee. And Huckabee's to his 16. Carter Hardwick, the left cornerback, stopped him. Michigan in a hole right now, trailing 14-3. Huckabee's career. Look at that, nearly 3,000 yards. And he missed three games this year with a bad knee. Third down, 4. Johnson, the tight end, is in. They're bringing the signals in, the tight end. Leach. Running, 15, 20. He has a first down.
That's what you call sucking it up, pal. He knew right where that first down yardage was. He had to lower his head. He had to take the lick, and he did it.
Yeah, he's rolling out here. He's looking to pass. I don't think this is an all-out run. I think he is looking to pass, but, you know, being the great All-American and athlete that he is, he knew he needed the first down, and he got what he needed.
A little more than he asked for.
You know, he has started 48 games. He's never been injured. 48 games. He was a starter as a freshman. Rick Leach from Flint, Michigan. A durable man. Drawback. He's under the gun. Out he comes. 25, 30. Goes down in the 34. He doesn't slide down. He takes them on.
He was looking for a hole that time, and rightly so. That was a play that only a great athlete can get out of. He's well hemmed in. SC's defensive ends are containing him very well, forcing him to the inside, hoping he can get some linebacker help. Dennis Johnson comes over late, and I think he took more of a lick than Rick.
Let me tell you, it looked like Earl Campbell on here. SC got a blitz going on. I think he is looking to throw the ball, but he rolls out blind. He rolled out the back way and just took off downfield, holding that ball like Earl holds that ball, doesn't he?
All right, well, they're marking for the first down to see if it is or not. It looks as if it's just an inch or two short. Dennis Johnson, this is the problem. A guy that can run all over the field creates for a down defensive lineman. Dennis Johnson's having a tough time. It's amazing to me that a freshman can start in a Rose Bowl game. He's held his own, but he's no match for Rick when it comes to running.
Yeah, he's hustling. Dennis Edwards is a kid, and he's hustling. And as I said, he was called into this game because Ty Sperling, the fine defensive end for SC, was hurt in the last game in Hawaii this year.
Leach holds the Michigan record passing yards, most touchdown passes, most total offense, and most rushing touchdowns, 34. You think of some of the backs he's had, Chapius, Tommy Harmon, Rob Lytle, some of those fellas. Quite an accomplishment for a quarterback, Rick Leach. Second down on their 33-yard line. Look at that time. That pass is no good. Incomplete at the 45 to Doug Marsh. He threw it low.
And I think as this game progresses, you're going to see him throwing that ball more and more because he's had men open. When he's had time to throw and he has thrown it well, he's hit people. They have been open on every occasion. It's just a matter of throwing and catching.
I think he got SC linebackers playing a little tentative also because they've had him dead to rights a few times and he spun out of it and ran for yardage. They're going to keep a closer eye on him. It may slow them up from getting into their passing lanes and passing responsibilities, and that's going to bring some guys open.
Third down, 10 to go. We have 37 seconds left in the first half. USC out in front, 14-3. They go for the run, and Huckabee is brought down right at the line of scrimmage on a quick low tackle by Ricky Gray. Leach is coming to the sideline. We have a timeout on the officials right now. With 31 seconds to go, Jim Beckler talking. Jim Beckler was kidding me. He said, don't ever put one of those mics around me in a game. He said, I'm too intense and I'm too emotional. You don't know what will happen.
No reflection.
Incidentally, there was a lot of press about that incident in the Fiesta Bowl. And We take all responsibility, NBC. We had the microphones down there. Lou Holtz wore one. We just stuck one in front of Terry Donahue. Terry Donahue, as O.J. and John knows, one of the finest young men we've ever run into, and a great young coach. He's been kidded a lot about it, but he didn't even know it happened. He really didn't. AFC Championship. And I want to tell you something. If that game is like the last game that they met in Houston, they were dropping like flies in that game. Bum Phillips says he's coached for 30 years, and that was the hardest hitting game he ever saw when Pittsburgh beat Houston 13-3. Houston defeated Pittsburgh at Pittsburgh, the only home loss for the Steelers this year. This is going to be one of the most bruising championship games we've ever had in the American Conference.
I'll tell you, you just mentioned Pittsburgh and Houston. There may not be enough players left on the winning team to play in the Super Bowl, but don't forget after this telecast, the Orange Bowl, Nebraska and Oklahoma.
What a game that's going to be. Talking about that Pittsburgh-Houston game, it's amazing how Earl Campbell has inspired that Houston team. I think in the last 4 or 5 years, I have never seen a team out-hit Houston. That last Pittsburgh game they had with them, it's the closest I've ever seen a team come to out-hitting Pittsburgh. I mean, Houston. The Pittsburgh Steelers, I was in their locker room after the 49er game. Hey, those guys are tight. Franco has about an inch and a half on his chest. Rocky them. The whole team is like that, and they're ready. It's going to be a hitting football game.
Oh, Jay, let me ask you something. When we talk about running backs, we start Jimmy Brown and you. I mean, let's face it, we're honest. The two greatest running backs we've known here in modern time. How do you rate Earl Campbell?
Earl is as fine a football player as I've ever seen on the football field. Not only as a runner, his ability to inspire the people around him. That whole team is playing better because of Earl Campbell. I mean, he's on the sideline. He's beating the linemen come off the field. He's making players play better than their potentials are. I mean, at least play up to their potential. And the man is amazing to me. I'm a fan of Earl Campbell's.
First down, Michigan from their 34 in the waning seconds of the first half. Leach is throwing the bomb to Clayton. Clayton's down there and he can't get it. And he was well covered along the way by Carter Hartwick. Carter Hartwick, a senior, second-string quarterback, had him all the way. Clayton can run. Clayton will write some poetry about that one. He writes poetry on the side.
Well, the poetry may go something like, I could not catch him. He had a lead of about 18 yards when the ball was thrown.
Well, I tell you, the ball was thrown perfectly, and if no one was in front of him, it would have fell right into his hand. I don't think he would have had to break stride, but he was defensed real well.
Now we're down to 19 seconds in the first half. If you join us late, USC scored first. Brenner, a third-string tight end, caught a touchdown pass. A short one of 9 yards. And Michigan had a field goal. And Charlie White plunged 3 yards for a touchdown. That ball's overthrown. It's grabbed by Dennis Smith. Smith's on the run to the 40 and is down on the 31. And we have 8 seconds to go in the first half as the clock stops. Leach overthrew his man.
Kurt, they've got time for one pass play to get the ball down within field goal range. They're about 3 or 4 yards short right at the time. I know that they do have a kicker that can kick pretty accurately, but not from 48 yards. Let's take a look. Leach, defensively, these fellas are 20, 25 yards deep. He's trying to hit over the top of the linebackers, in between the defensive safety men. Dennis Smith is standing right in center field in the perfect place to pick it off.
Seventh interception this year. SC has an interesting situation here. They can throw maybe a quick pass and get in field goal range or try for the long one and have no time in the half. But as you can see, the guy is open. The ball is thrown over. I think he was trying to throw over a linebacker and have it drop in. I don't think he's developed that touch just yet. And Dennis Smith was waiting for it.
Now, Dennis Smith, by the way, is a sophomore. That's his seventh interception this year. And he was a state high jump champ.
Let me tell you a story about that. He hadn't high jumped in 2 years. And this year they brought him out for the UCLA meet and he jumped 7 feet.
7 feet?
7 feet after not jumping for a year.
Not bad.
They let him out of spring training.
Maybe we'll see him in Moscow, huh?
Maybe.
All right. 8 seconds to go in the half. USC has the ball in the Michigan 30. White's out of motion. They'll spread them all out. McDonald's toss to the sideline, and it is complete.
And There's still 2 seconds left, so they've got plenty of time to kick a field goal.
That was absolutely perfect, because if he'd have caught the ball inbounds, I don't think they could have gotten up and got the clock stopped in time. He caught the ball right at the sideline, went out of bounds, and Frank Jordan, a guy who's had some big moments, is on the field now to maybe have another biggie.
And the play was made possible by an excellent fake on McDonald's part.
And a lot of time.
Frank Jordan, whose longest kick this year has been 40 yards, will try a 35-yarder. 10 out of 19 for him.
With 2 seconds left. He beat UCLA with 2 seconds left last year, beat Notre Dame with 2 seconds left this year, and with 2 seconds left, he kicks another one in the Rose Bowl.
He's a two-second man. That's the third game with 2 seconds to go at a half or game at the end of a game that he's kicked a field goal. So the opportunist Trojans intercept, throw a pass, then kick a field goal, and grab a last-second score.
Now, you want to talk about a two-second drill? Well, here's the SC two-second drill. Of course, the clock was stopped. Right down the middle. He's had some big moments as a Trojan.
He acts like, well, it's automatic, gentlemen. Just down, pick up my towel, and that's it. Well, that's the end of the first half here from Pasadena, California. And the score is USC 17 and Michigan 3. Kurt Gowdy, John Brody, O.J. Simpson, halftime score 17-3, USC. We've had a first at the Rose Bowl. This is the 65th Rose Bowl game. We had an earthquake, a 4.1 reading on the Richter scale, and a definite earthquake, y'all. We didn't feel anything up here. I thought O.J. was moving over there a little bit.
I've lived through a few earthquakes out here in California, but you want to see a stadium empty. You would have seen a record emptying of a stadium if the fans would have known it was earthquake going on.
Yeah, we'd have been sitting in El Segundo. That's.
I always tease Reggie McKenzie. I said, no, we're going to be an island. We're not falling into the sea. We're going to be an island. You're going to have to pay a lot of money to come out with.
All right, now remember today in the Sugar Bowl, Alabama defeated previously unbeaten Penn State 14-7. USC has lost only one game this year. They defeated Alabama early in the year. Michigan has lost only one game. And those Michigan fans. So the importance here is if USC wins with the defeat over Alabama earlier, that is really going to stir up a national debate who's the mythical champ, and Penn State losing Michigan. If it rallies to win, they would have quite an argument.
And don't think that the score is any indication of the way this ball game has gone. Michigan has taken them on at the line of scrimmage. They've played head to toe with them. I think they played every bit as well. They got one touchdown gift given to USC. We mentioned earlier that Rick Leach has to have a good day for Michigan to win. He is so instrumental to their offense. That's Paul McDonald, who has had a pretty good day up to now. But Rick is 2 for 10 with 2 interceptions. Both those balls were poorly thrown. I think we'll see a lot more throws in this half, and they can get right back in it.
Tony Jackson is nailed deep in his own territory on the kickoff. And down there covering is Kenny Moore, a sophomore from San Fernando. So Michigan has the ball on their 21-yard line. Remember the Orange Bowl coming up next. Two of the high-powered offensive teams in the nation, Nebraska against Oklahoma. The first game, 17-14, Nebraska winning.
You know, Kurt, you were talking about SC's phenomenal second quarter. They outscored the opponent 10-3 in the second quarter today, but Michigan is noted for their third quarter.
Let's see how they're doing it. Roosevelt Smith is starting the second half. And he hits one over the 25 to about the 26-yard line. Stopped by Ricky Gray and Larry McGrew. Your backfield, Rick Leach, the quarterback. Roosevelt Smith is the tailback. Russell Davis is the fullback. They're alternating the tight ends. Doug Marsh coming on the field in place of Gene Johnson. Feaster and Clayton are the wide receivers. Geisler, Powers, Nada, Bartnick, and Dufek are up front. Second down, 5, Michigan. On their 26. Piled up is Russell Davis. Davis piled up by Ricky Gray and Larry McGrew.
The play that Russell was just running is what they call a 32 trap. You know, SC had some success on one series running a 32 trap when we saw Kane shooting up the middle. And you know what SC got that play from? Michigan. 2 years ago when they were playing Michigan, they couldn't stop Rob Hurdle on that play, so they start running Rick Kane on that play.
Let's take a look. You know, you're talking about the effectiveness of people up front. I really think it's been pretty even that way. You see the real problem statistically, 2 for 10 for Leach. That's got to improve.
Leach flares it out. He hits his receiver. That is Roosevelt Smith. And Smith is close to a first down, tackled by Brazil.
Roosevelt Smith made an excellent play to get the first down. They may measure, but it's a first down. A back must know where that 10-yard chain is. He knew, had to make a good individual move, got by the two linebackers, picked up the first. Well-thrown ball out in the flat, hits him right on the run.
And this is the same play they threw to Huckabee a couple of times in the first half. As I said, they had a first down one time, and he dropped the ball the other time. But each time, the guy has been open for positive yardage.
First down, Michigan on their own 32-yard line. Alan Mitchell going in motion. The handoff is to Roosevelt Smith. He breaks it out to the 38-yard line, hit there by Rich Dimmler. You saw the total yards in the first half. 74 for Michigan, 63 for USC. These two teams both averaged over 400 yards a game in offense during the season. So they have really run against a couple of tough defenses.
Well, you bet. They haven't played this kind of defensive team, either one of them.
When you play teams like this on defense, you have to take advantages of the mistakes. SC capitalized on an interception early. They got a break for a touchdown later, and Michigan didn't capitalize on a fumble.
Second down, 5. Leach to the tailback. That's Roosevelt Smith. He's stopped by Charles Moses, the weak side linebacker, number 55 in the game, a senior from Ontario, California. They are on their own 41-yard line. They have third down and a yard to go. John Robinson, his third year. He's had 2 seasons, 11-1. Last year, they had a slump, 8-4. But he's taken them to 3 bowl games in a row. Third down and 1. They run the option. Roosevelt Smith. And he does not have it. Great pursuit there by the Rover, Ron Lott, number 42, who chased him across and wouldn't let him get up to that yardstick.
And SC's defensive quickness is so astounding that they just let Leach kind of keep going, work himself into a corner with the sideline. They've got such fine pursuit, they just let him go nowhere. Here comes Rick. He's coming out. He's looking for somebody to option on. However, there is nobody. They're attacking from the inside out. Their cornerbacks are coming up. Their Wolfman makes a great play. They're in punting situation.
Greg Wilner to punt. Bayman Butler is the deep man. Kicks that off the side of his foot. It's to the short man on the 35-yard line, and catching that ball was Willie Crawford. So USC will go on the attack early in the third period. It is USC 17 and Michigan 3. Southern Cal will put the ball in play on their own 35-yard line. Michigan lining up. They'll have Turgovac at middle guard. Greer and Kites flanking him. And there goes Lynn Kane. He's been the top ball carrier for USC. Lynn Kane right up the middle, and the free safety had to bang him down.
As I said, where they got that play for, it's called a 32 trap. Here it is, right up. It's just a trap right up the middle, and they got that play from Michigan. Coach Robinson said that they tried to defense this play in practice and never could do it, so they decided to put it in.
And very effectively.
2 years ago, yes. Yeah.
Kane had 38 yards rushing in the first half. Charlie White held a 35. There goes White. And White's into Michigan territory. Stumbling down on the Michigan 47. Ron Simpkins, number 40, brought him down. Anytime White goes below 100 yards, that's news. Southern Cal on the Michigan. Let's call it the Michigan 48. Second down, 6. Buck Williams in motion. At the 46-yard line, Charlie White hit by Mark Brayman and Ron Simpkins again.
Boy, and when that Ron Simpkins hits you, he lays the wood.
Third and 4 for USC on the Michigan 46. White now 41 yards, 17 carries.
He paid a price for every one of those yards.
It's less than 3 yards average for him a carry. He averaged 147 yards a game this year on the ground. They're going to run White for it. White is stopped at the 43-yard line. He appears to be short of the first down. Again, Ron Simpkins, number 40. We have a flag dropped.
All right. They say they try to keep their offensive blockers away from him, give him a chance to get to the ball carrier. You can see they're trying to shield him, but he handles the blocker that does get on him and keeps him short of a first down.
This penalty appears to be going against USC. They were penalized only once in the first half for 5 yards. They're marking this one off.
And a lot of people would ask, why would they take a penalty when it's fourth down and two and they felt he might have to punt? However, I don't think USC would have elected to punt. They were well into Michigan territory. They could have kept their drive alive by getting a yard and a half. Now they're in no man's land, third and 20.
But I don't think 20 is right.
I don't think at this point in time, Coach Robinson is going to try to pick it all up now. They have a 17-3 lead. He probably played very conservative at this point in time.
There goes White in motion. 10 minutes to play in the third period.
Shows how much I know.
McDonald's going to fumble. And who has it? USC recovered.
Looked like John Geisler.
Jerry Meter was there. And then Keith Van Horn got underneath him. Meter had the first shot at it. Let it get away from him.
This is the same thing that happened to him earlier in the game when he fumbled. He didn't even see the man, and you can see he paid the price. He dropped the ball, and that's one of the reasons they should have ran a conservative play.
Well, that's good. That hindsight's 20-20, pal.
Marty King in punt formation. Time on the official. Marty King in the first half averaged 48 yards a punt, mostly on the bounce.
Well, I've gotten a little more respect for Paul McDonald. He's taking some shots today, and he's still coming back in there playing.
Michael Jolly is the safety man.
They're going to try and do what they can to block this punt.
They go after him. Another low boot. Jolly takes it under 35. He's to the 40. Oh, he ran into that red-shirted wall that's always down there. They really get down there on those punts, even without a hang time on the punt. Michigan's ball first down when we return. It is still Southern Cal 17 and Michigan 3. We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network. Kurt Gowdy, John Brody, O.J. Simpson in the Rose Bowl. Michigan has a first down on their own 40-yard line. They're 14 points behind. They're approaching the midway mark of the third period. Leach is looking. Flares it out. He's got up to Roosevelt Smith. And Smith is stopped at the 46 by Gary Kopp, the strong side out linebacker.
Kurt, they're giving him that pass. I think it's very sane if they take advantage of it, pick it up on first down. One of these times he's going to break away from those linebackers trying to recover. They're giving up everything, going into the middle of the field, trying to make a tough throw for Leach to get to one of his wide receivers. As a result, he's leaving his backs open. I just wouldn't stop throwing it until they covered it.
Gary Cobb, number 53, slid right along with him. Roosevelt Smith had 4 catches today. He had only 5 in the regular season. Second down, 4. The option. Leach on the pitch out to Smith. Smith tumbled down in USC territory at the USC 47. But that's enough for a first down. And the safety man, Dennis Smith, made the hit on him.
And when the safety men have to come up on an option play and get into the act, you know it's a successful play. That's the first time I've seen Leach run the option to the wide side where he had some room to use his head. When he pitched the ball out, he'd already picked up 6-7 yards, and they have moved it very convincingly so far in the third quarter.
Yes, he was into a blitz. They had Ron Lott, the rover, coming in, but he was picked up quite effectively by Russell Davis. Sort of stuck it to him pretty good there.
First down, Michigan, USC 47. That's a good hit on Roosevelt Smith. You saw him line up in an eye with a wing back in the eye. That's Clayton coming out of motion. Jim Becker said he wants to do some of that stuff so that USC will be hesitant on defense. They don't want to just have them line up and expect the formation and just what to come out of it.
Dennis Johnson didn't look too hesitant to me.
Roosevelt Smith's been busy here in the third period. Second down, 9. Michigan on the USC 46. Alan Mitchell in motion. Leach will throw. Now he's going to fumble the ball loose. Scrambles for it. Out of bounds. Everybody's there. He's smothered by those players, our viewpoint, on the Michigan sideline.
It looked to me like Leach made a pretty good last-ditch effort to get his hand on the ball and get it out of bounds. He knew he was in trouble. Fumbled it forward. He comes back. It looks like he's got a receiver, Clayton, open. However, the ball hits off his knees as he's tucking it in, trying to run. When he did go down, he did put his hand out.
Well, I think those left-handed quarterbacks, you know, Kenny Stabler, those left-handed quarterbacks got something about those forward fumbles.
And, of course, an unusual game today with two starting left-handers. 39-yard line of USC. Third down and 2 to go for Michigan. 7 minutes to play in the third period. Flies go down. Do they take too much time? 25 seconds to run a playoff in college football. They did. John, you think he was checking off?
I don't really know. I think he had a play call. It was an option play, and I don't think you would check off in that circumstance. It didn't look to me as if he was going back to throw the balls. There wouldn't be any reason to have done so. I think they were just a little late getting out of the huddle.
Yeah, they didn't spend much time on the line of scrimmage then.
There's a man you just saw, that's a legal delay, John Robinson, who said he started the Rose Bowl game when he played up at Oregon. The last 7 seconds of the game, he came in, and the other club quarterback ran back and fell on the ball, according to Robinson, because he was scared of Robinson's entrance into the game. And the game was over. So he had a very short Rose Bowl history as a player. Back to the 44 of USC. Third down and 7. Leach fakes. Look at him pursuing. He better throw. He throws on the run. He's got him. And it is a touchdown, Michigan. Roosevelt Smith got the ball. He beat Dennis Smith. He beat Dennis Smith, and Michigan's right back in.
I don't know, Kurt, what it is that Bo Schembechler does at halftime, but they did the same thing last year in the Rose Bowl. Washington looked like they were running all over the top of them. This game has not gone at all like that one did, but the score has. Now he puts it back in the ball game with a beautifully thrown ball across his body in the middle of the field. One of the toughest to throw, and he hits him right on the dead run.
A 44-yard pass. Rick Leach, under extreme pressure, hit Roosevelt Smith down the middle, and Roosevelt Smith has been the busiest man on the field here in the third quarter.
And I said that there's something about Michigan's third quarter. You know, I think they've outscored their opponent something like 90-10 in the third quarter, and it's sure showing true here today.
There's the kick. It is up, and the kick is good by Craig Wilner. So we'll have a timeout. 7 minutes to go in the third period. And the score is USC 17, Michigan 10. They have a powerhouse college basketball schedule for you this winter on NBC. Let's look at the touchdown play again.
All right, it's only the great athletes that can get into a bad situation to make a big play out of it. His intended receiver was covered. Clayton down the sideline, you can see him motioning to do something to get open. He's got 4 or 5 cats all over him. And that's a very hard throw across your body into the middle of the field when you're running to the side you throw from. Roosevelt Smith takes it in easily, and it is now 17-10.
That was all Rick Leach, you know. Everybody's worried about his running abilities. The safeties forgot about the receivers were coming up to help out, and he put it on the money. He made it all happen.
There's the kick coming to Raymond Butler on the 3, 15, 20. Down he goes on his 24-yard line.
John Brody, you know, there's a possibility that this game could end up in a tie. Now, what would that do to the pitch of the national championship?
I've got no clue, and I'm very thankful that I don't have to make any decision about it, but obviously to me it would be Alabama. You can't get by with a tie on the last ball game and win when the team that's second has already won.
There's Robinson and the great history of his Rose Bowl participation, 7 seconds.
coached up there. He's a coach here under John McKay for 3 years, coached under the Oakland Raiders, and back again as head coach. There's a deep handoff to the tailback, Charles White. And he's again hit by Ron Sipp. The touchdown again.
As you can see, he was under a lot of pressure. He wanted to just set up and throw. He started running. Strangely, the SC bench was arguing that he was over the line of scrimmage, but you'll see here that he definitely wasn't.
That's the 46-yard line where he let it go. The line of scrimmage was the 44. Leach just threw his 17th touchdown pass of the year on that one. Second down, 7. 27-yard line at USC. Lynn Cain is piled up. That's the first time they stopped him up the middle. He's been getting some bursts of 5, 8, 10 yards. Curtis Greer was in his way. Number 95, the right tackle. On the 31, 3rd and 3. 17 to 10 now. USC leading. We've had a disputed touchdown in the first half. The Orange Bowl, Oklahoma, Nebraska, coming up right after this game in Miami. Charlie White. White runs for the first down. That little burst of speed took him outside.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing he has the speed, because that play didn't look like it was going to work. He had a lot of penetration on it. It hadn't worked all day, but it was the speed of Charles White to get outside to get the first down.
Placed the ball on the USC 36. Look at the USC tailbacks. They have become the royalty of football, and OJ's one of the kings. White, Davis, Ricky Bell, OJ, and Garrett. OJ and Ricky Bell were the two biggest ones. White's about 185. He's up at the 45, and he's to the 50 for another first down. Charlie White starting to move now. Mike Jolly stopped him.
But Charlie could have been gone all the way that time. But little Kevin Williams, a lot of times you want your wide receivers to just take a shot at the cornerback. Make him move, and he didn't take a shot. He's kind of standing out there trying to see what the corner is going to do. And Charles just had to shoot upfield, as you see, ran right by him and just went upfield for the first down.
He has 68 yards. He had only 35 in the first half. Strong formation right. White. White slithers for a couple of yards, and that's all. To the 48-yard line of Michigan. Tackled by Ron Simpkin. This Simpkin is a some linebacker.
Well, I say, other than the second quarter, when Lynn Cain got some positive yards up the middle, this is about the most impressive drive SC has had. They haven't had any real impressive drive today. They've taken advantage of some mistakes by Michigan, but this is the first time they really look like they're moving the football, and the guys up front maybe beginning to control Michigan somewhat.
Throws and is incomplete at the 21. Mark Grayman was there. That's the bug, Williams.
And you just have an innate sense as a quarterback where that line of scrimmage was. That was about as close as he could possibly cut it. However, he's had a bad ankle as we watch Sweeney go down the field. He's trying to come all the way across. Now he sees McDonald has a problem. He's trying to come over and help. Did the best thing he could under the circumstance. McDonald gave him the ball in the only place he could handle it, and he just dropped it as he hit the ground. All right, we discussed how a quarterback just has a sense of knowing where that line of scrimmage is. Now he's just running. All of a sudden, he feels that the ball's about at the line of scrimmage and lets it go.
They flood three receivers to the left on 3rd and 8. McDonald looks him over right down the middle. Falling down was Sweeney, and it was nearly intercepted by Mark Grayman. Sweeney, Calvin Sweeney, fell down, and it was nearly intercepted by Grayman.
And I think the impressive thing defensively to me about Michigan, they said they don't play against too many throwing teams. However, the Big Ten has changed. I'll tell you, Darryl Rogers, Lee Corso, these guys have changed that thing. They played excellent defensive back play. And I think it's kept McDonald from being as effective as he has been all year. Simpkins tries to get his hand in the act, too.
There's the kick by Marnie King. And it is into the end zone for a touchback. Michigan's ball first down on their own 20. We have 4 minutes, 21 seconds left in this third period. The score is Southern Cal 17, Michigan 10. another blimp-side view of the Rose Bowl as she circles to bring you these exciting aerial shots of the Trojans and the Wolverines. The United States Olympic Committee will receive the net proceeds from an additional commercial scheduled in this program under an agreement made with NBC for the broadcast of the United States Olympic Trials. NBC acknowledges the cooperation of the Pac-10 Conference and the Pasadena Tournament of Roses Association in helping to broadcast that commercial announcement. 20-yard line of Michigan, first down. They have scored in the third period on a Leach to Smith 44-yard pass. Southern Cal has not scored. Davis and Smith are the running backs. Clayton in motion. Leach on the keeper. Out to Smith. Up in him at the 21-yard line. Ron Lott, the rover from Rialto, California, sophomore.
You may be wondering why Huckabee is not in the game. I think he's been having a lot of problems in practice. He hasn't been, he's been injured quite a bit, and I didn't think he was running with a lot of authority early in the game. Now his replacement is doing an excellent job. There he is on the sideline. Well, he was there.
Roosevelt Smith's been doing the job, and I think that's why he's standing there right now.
Yeah. Roosevelt had a couple of big games. He went for over 150 yards against Wisconsin this year.
They flare it out. Roosevelt Smith, 25, down on the 26-yard line. Dennis Smith coming up to banging down. A gain of 4, third and 4 for Michigan. They want this first down to keep it going. 3.5 minutes remain in the third period. They're trailing by 7.
Having played with a lot of Michigan ball players, I knew Michigan's a philosophy in the past, Bo's philosophy, is that, hey, we're going to go out and out hit them, and the fourth quarter is ours. They try to wear their opponents down and win the game in the fourth quarter. They want to stay close until the fourth quarter, and this game is only a 7-point difference. I think they feel pretty good right now.
Third down, 4. Good work. He just threw that one out of desperation. He had to get rid of it.
They were trying to get a screen pass. They were trying to get a screen off, Kurt. The screen was handled by the linebackers. It was very well played defensively. He had nowhere to go. He did the only thing he could.
Rick Leach will come over and talk to his coach. Punt formation, Greg Wilner will boot it and set to handle the return is Raymond Butler. Remember, Alabama beat Penn State today. In the minds of many, the winner of this game could be right in there, up high in the votes for the mythical national champion. USC defeated Alabama earlier in the year. USC's played 5 bowl teams. Butler, the 36. Butler escaping and then back to the 37, and that's all. First down. Sports World returns Sunday, the 14th, bringing you year-round coverage of major sports. You're going to see the Wembley Invitational Gymnastic Championship from Wembley, England. And top performers from Hungary, Romania, the Soviet Union, Great Britain, the best in the world. Then we'll have the Muhammad Ali Invitational Track and Field Championships in Long Beach. And the crazy world of sport, the touch of the offbeat, mixed with a touch of the absurd. There goes Charlie White. Charlie White starting to pick him up now. Tom Sebrun, the outside linebacker, stopped him, but it's a first down USC.
And they're going to keep picking it up as long as their tackles, Keith Van Horn, Otis Page, do the kind of job they've been doing with Lynn Cain blocking in front of White. They know they haven't been as effective as they're accustomed to being throwing the ball. They've got to move people up front.
2:20 to play in the third period. Trojans on the Michigan 47. Kane stopped at the 45-yard line. Lynn Kane. Mike Turgovac, the middle guard, and Jerry Meter, one of the co-captains.
Well, SC's got to take advantage. This quarter, they've been getting some pretty good field position, and that just doesn't happen the whole games, and they got to take some advantage of that. They got to get a score in this quarter, hopefully on this drive, or it's going to give the momentum to Michigan, I think, going into the fourth quarter.
Second down, 8. Rock the Shan in motion. Charlie White, he goes down. He may have lost a yard. Mark Raymond really played that well, number 28. They bring him to the turf. Third coming for USC. They have a third and eight. Let's check the passing figures for McDonald. He's only attempted seven and completed four.
For 23 yards. That's not what you call a blockbuster.
Well, way below his seasonal output. Bug Williams going out to the right. Third and eight. Going to the Bug, and he fell down. Williams fell down. They're slipping a lot here.
Kevin Williams, 155-pounder, but he's an all-Pac-10 receiver. Gets a one-on-one coverage. He's got him in a good position, but he can't keep his feet. Ball's thrown just a little behind him. Had he kept his feet, he could have moved inside and grabbed it.
Marty King punting. Mike Jolly again, the safety. A high kick. Fair catch call. Jolly fields it on his 10-yard line. Michigan will put the ball in play with 43 seconds to go in the third quarter. The Orange Bowl right after this one. The Orange Bowl, the Nebraska team led by running backs I.M. Hip, Rick Byrne. They were second in the nation in both rushing offense and scoring offense. First in total defense. And you know how Oklahoma can run the ball. Suddenly, now the Nebraska people were disappointed. Now they're anxious for that rematch down there. They want to show that the victory over Oklahoma was no fluke. First down, Michigan on their 11. Leach. Out it goes to Roosevelt Smith. I haven't seen Michigan do this in previous Rose Bowls, throw deep in their own territory.
Well, they wanted to throw the ball deep also, but it was very well played by Lavender. Gave the wide receiver no room at all. Leach had to come up, and that's the first time the linebackers have pursued well on the halfback.
Well, I said that's the same play they've been running a lot. They try to run the receiver into the flat. They run the linebacker, the halfback. They loop him out of the backfield. Hopefully, he'll cover, he'll bring the cornerback up, and they try to hit the receiver going down the sideline.
Second down, 10. Roosevelt Smith stopped at the 12-yard line. He's hit there by Dennis Edwards, the freshman, a phenom at right tackle, and another freshman, Ricky Gray, the weak side linebacker. Third down, 9 to go for Michigan. They may not get the playoff before the gun of the third quarter sounds. Wind is no factor, so it doesn't matter. There's the gun. And the end of the third quarter of the 65th Rose Bowl game with the score of the University of Southern California 17 and the University of Michigan 10. Kurt Gowdy, John Brody, O.J. Simpson take you into the fourth period. Michigan has outgained USC total offense. Michigan 172 yards, USC 131. And Michigan's had the ball 23 minutes and 7 seconds, USC 21 minutes and 53 seconds. About even on possession. This is third down. The 12-yard line of Michigan, third and 8. Play action pass. Leach runs it out. He stopped at the 17. He's short of a first down. Dennis Johnson, the linebacker, pulled him down. So they'll have to punt. Greg Wilner again. This has turned into a punting duel this second half.
Tried, and it keeps giving SC good field position. Juice mentioned it earlier. You can't contain a good offensive football team if you give it to them 5 or 6 times in one half that way.
Well, SC has not been taking advantage of it. They've had a good field position throughout the second half now, and they haven't gotten any points from it, and they're going to have to score here if they want to preserve this lead.
Kick is to Butler in the 42. Butler trying to get outside. 45, 50. His speed got him out there. Yeah. So his outside speed enabled him to pick up 7 or 8 extra yards, and the Trojans had the ball on the 46-yard line of Michigan with a score 17-10 USC, 14 minutes to go. McDonald, White is buried. He ran under Tom Sebrin, number 91, and Curtis Greer, number 95. And that's a loss to the Michigan 48, a second and 12.
Well, as I said before, I think Michigan's defensive line has controlled fairly much this game. SC and Spurs have had some effect, been effective running the ball, but they certainly haven't done running the ball what they wanted to do and what they usually do.
McDonald is going to throw.
Come on.
Maybe he didn't. That's Curtis Greer. He's been a terror here in the second half. Greer right in there on him, 95 for a big loss.
Kurt, again, he had nobody open downfield. I tell you, the defensive backs for Michigan are covering those receivers like blankets. They're covering awfully good people, too. Can't throw it if you can't get any time.
Third down and 17. Right now, the margin of this game is on a controversial touchdown scored by Charles White. A goal line plunge with the ball popping loose. Looked like it popped loose before he got to the goal line. And the bomb to the Bug. The Bug's there, but it's way over his head. Bug Williams had steps on Michael Harden, but the ball was beyond his reach.
Yeah, Paul threw it just a little too soon. He had a little more time. If he had waited a fraction of a second, I think SC could have been putting 6 points on the board.
And again, John, SC failed to take advantage of their field position.
They have, but they've been able to keep Michigan in a hole, and something's going to bust.
There's a kick by Marty King. Jolly takes it, and immediately he is knocked down. That was a great charge. Dennis Smith went down to hit him. Michigan again deep in their own territory with the ball in the fourth period. And again the score, 17-10 Trojans. There are 12 minutes, 35 seconds remaining in this Rose Bowl game. Here's the punt.
Okay, it really helps when you don't have to let your lineman delay until the ball is kicked before you can go downfield. You get good pursuit. Dennis Smith's been playing that ball all day long.
We almost had a roughing the receiver penalty there. So anyway, Michigan has been in the hole the whole second half. John Brody seemed to think that they're going to come out with a play-action pass on this play.
They want to get out of the hole.
But they give the ball up the middle to Russell Davis. Russell Davis runs into Ricky Gray. The two freshmen again combining for USC in the tackle. Edwards the right tackle, Gray the inside linebacker.
Gray has had 5 solo tackles this game and it's been in on 3 assists. He's an excellent freshman, excellent prospect.
It's amazing to me how freshmen can walk in now, John, and start in their first year.
I thought they could have when I was playing ball, but it was a rule against it at that time, and it was a good rule.
Second down, 8. Leach spinning around.
Look at that.
There's a great throw. That's the tight end, Doug Marsh, with the ball. Shows you what an athlete Leach is. He's down
Rick
as
Leach.
He was hit. How he got rid of that ball, I'll never know.
That's the sort of thing you can't coach. He knows his team depends on him to get out of the hole. As he goes back to throw, he's barely the first man back there. Lapka's in good shape. Dennis Johnson almost brings him down. He gets away, and just as he gets hit, he throws the ball, and I think his knee just buckled under him a bit, but they did get a big play, and they're out of a hole.
Well, some of the SC players were arguing that his knee touched the ground, and he was down, and it was pretty close, but I think he got it off. He's an excellent football player. He's making it all happen for Michigan.
They have a first down. Leach keeps it on the keeper and goes to the 31-yard line. Ricky Gray again. Now we have the freshman in there. Butch Woolfolk. Big, strong tailback from Westfield, New Jersey. who is the fastest player ever recruited at Michigan for either track or football. He has run the 100 meters in 10-1. He weighs 198. You'll be hearing a lot of him. Second down, 7. Wolverines on their 31. There he is. Butch Wolfolk. And Myron Lapka wrapped him up. Welcome to the Rose Bowl, son. Yard line. They have a big third down play now. They're trailing Michigan 17-10. 10.5 minutes to go in this game. Defensive struggle here in the second half. Only one touchdown. That's scored by Michigan. 44-yard pass. Leach to Roosevelt Smith. Smith back in at tailback. Leach is going to throw. The protection. He runs out of the pocket. Just to the 30. Dives down. He's short of a first down in the 34. Fell in front of Gary Cobb. They were all covered.
I tell you, the man is so agile. He's such a fine athlete. It's virtually impossible to sack him unless you bring one or two linebackers. They're rushing three men. He's just picking his way through there, and I think he can run for 5 yards all day long just by setting up the pass and taking off.
And five was just about four short that time, yep. So they've got the punt. And again, they got out of the hole, but they have to get a sustained drive.
If I was them, I swear, I'd drop back the throw on first down. If he finds the receiver open, throw, if not run, and I think he'd get 5-6 yards every first down.
Greg Wilner boots it to Butler, calls for a fair catch at the 34. Both teams are jockeying now, waiting for something to happen. A fumble, an interception, some kind of a break. 9 minutes, 22 seconds to go in the game. Still at 17-10, USC. The usual warm hospitality from the Tournament of Roses Committee, Art Welsh, the president, Bill Nicholas, the chairman of the football committee, Bob Cheney, Stan Hahn, Leigh Leishman, Red Soldwell, and Frank Hardcastle. Lynn Kane of Los Angeles, up the middle. He has not tried to go wide once in this game. Stopped by Dale Kites and Andy Canavino. Kane has rushed for 57. Charlie White has rushed for 85. A mediocre day for Charlie.
But the day isn't over.
Nope. Second down, 6. There's White. White out to the 43. White is 183, but much stronger than you think he'd be. Very, very compact, a hard hitter.
Okay, when his offensive linemen move people out of there, he can get going. However, you saw Otis Page stood up at the line of scrimmage. He has moved people out earlier during the day. He did not that time. White picked up 4 or 5 on his own. They've got it down to 3rd and 1.
I saw the center, you know, Ray Peters, get up. He was limping quite a bit. If he goes out of the game, they have to put their 7th-string center in. That could be a problem.
3rd and 1, USC. White, first down. 46-yard line of USC.
Don't think White is not paying a price every time he goes in there. He's getting tagged. He's getting up in the air quite a bit. Michigan has a lot of, their defensive line is not a huge defensive line. They get low, they get under the big guys. It forces the back to go up and over the top, and you're vulnerable when you're in the air. And Charles can take some pretty good shots coming down from trying to leap over that defensive line.
First down, Trojans are 46. They're ahead 17-10, midway in the fourth period. There goes Kane. That time he tried outside tackle, Lynn Kane. Gene Bell, the Wolfman, slid over there. They'll wrap him up. Put it on the USC 49, a gain of 3, and 2nd and 7.
Well, it's a gain of about 3.5, and I think they consider that a successful play. Any time they can get near 4 yards on first down from the fullback, SC considers that a very successful play.
The lights are on here in the Rose Bowl, by the way. 2nd down, 7. Charlie White And he picks up five more. He goes to the Michigan 46. This is just old bread and butter football right now. Straight ahead, bang it out, keep the ball. We're in the lead. Ron Simpkins again made the tackle for the University of Michigan.
Now they've got a long two and a half.
Interesting back. Escape with her life here against Notre Dame. That USC has had some second half troubles during the year.
Well, something's happening now. Charles White has just ran off the field. As I said, he's been paying a price running in there, and I don't know if he shook up.
We'll check this out. And while we do, again, the score is USC 17 and Michigan 10. Third down and two play for USC on the Michigan 46. Trojan back.
You know, I don't think SC really wanted to call a timeout. I think Charles White was a little shook up. He went to the sidelines, and I think they called a timeout just to keep him into the game.
Michigan digging in. There's White. They got him. They nailing for a loss of the 49. Andy Canavito, who has been brilliant today as an inside linebacker. His father, Joe, played for Ohio State here in the 1958 Rose Bowl game.
And that's where it's tough. Third down and two, third down and three. Watch Andy Canavino shoot right through the hole. He does in perfect position to bring down Charles White. They're forcing another turnover.
Again, a punt. The deepest penetration for Michigan in this third, fourth period has been to their own 34-yard line. They have not had field position. They've got to hit a long pass, break the run, or start a drive, and they're now down to 5:58 remaining. Just checking my running play-by-play after that pass to Smith. They have been pinned back deep in their own territory since midway in the third period. No field position whatsoever. The kick by Marty King. Jolly on the 10. Jolly belted down. They'll put him along the 11-yard line. All right, we'll be back once again. Michigan again backed up toward their own goal line. 17-10 USC. Much talk about rematches coming up next to the Orange Bowl. Oklahoma, Nebraska, right here on NBC. Down on the field, Michigan in their huddle. They're on their 11-yard line. They have a first down. They have not had any operating room whatsoever here in this fourth period or late in the third quarter. And they have 5 minutes and 42 seconds to try and do something. Leach to Jackson. Jackson. I thought he wanted to pass. He does pass. Throws it up in the stands. He was hit as he let it go. That was a flanker reverse with a pass coming off the reverse.
Well, you know you've got to do something if you're Michigan. SC's kicking game has kept Michigan in the hole since midway through the third quarter. Since they scored their first, their only touchdown, they have not had good field position. That play, a little fooler play, looked as if had the man not been trying to go with the throw all the way, he might have turned a corner.
Well, I think so. I think what Michigan is thinking also is the time now. They have to put the ball up in the air. They've got to preserve some time on the clock, that if they're not successful throwing the ball, at least they won't waste much time and will be able to get the ball again.
Tony Jackson,
a better position.
Tony Jackson went out. Ralph Clayton replaced him. It was Charlie Moses that hurried Tony Jackson on that throw. Now Leach is back to pass. He shoots it out. There he is. He's got a receiver for a first down. That's Ralph Clayton. Clayton caught the ball up around his 30-yard line, tackled immediately by Larry Brazil, the cornerback.
All right, Rick Leach does it in the toughest of circumstances. It's a one-man pattern. He's got Clayton going down deep into the zone area, behind the linebackers. Leach puts the ball over the top of Dennis Johnson, right where it has to be thrown. They get out of a hole, and they've got about 5 minutes and 27 seconds to do something.
And Clayton is down. Let's watch him again.
All right. Perfect turn. Just the way you draw it up. Gives himself a lot of leeway to go for the ball wherever it's thrown. When you take a look. When a man is running against his own defense, just to come flying across there doesn't do you much good. He gives himself an opportunity to move wherever the ball is thrown. Leach is under a lot of pressure, puts it in the hole that exposes itself, and Clayton brings it down.
And we're waiting to see what's with Clayton. He's flipping off, as you see. I don't believe it's serious. Back every step, he's getting a little more confidence. But he's going to be replaced as he comes off.
Well, it looks to me like Leach's adrenaline is flowing. You know, the stage is set. He's a senior. He started 4 years. He's never won out here. I think the stage is set for Rick Leach to go out in a flurry here. He certainly put that last pass on the money.
He hands off to Roosevelt Smith. And you had some great pursuit there by Myron Lapka, the left tackle, and Dimmler, the nose guard. They're a tough couple of fellas to run against, along with the right tackle, that freshman Dennis Edwards, who's been such an excellent pass rusher today. 32-yard line of Michigan. Second and 8. I'll tell you, there's a beautiful scene right now here. Pasadena, the sun, the setting sun is hitting the San Gabriel Mountains. And there's a sort of a pinkish color in those mountains. It's beautiful. Second down, 8. Play action pass. The throw. Pop! Out of bounds. Gene Johnson, the tight end.
You find me, Kurt, a better thrown ball than that one, and I will put in with it. He had the toughest possible throw to make. He could. He had to get it over the top of Ron Lott, who was covering Johnson all the way. Johnson had only a step. He's throwing it, running as fast as he can to get away from the pressure. They're putting a lot of people in on Leach. They know they've got to do something. They can't let him stand back there. Throws it on the run. Hits it right over the shoulder. Johnson gets 1 foot in. And that's all you need in college football.
That's the first time they've hit him. First down, Michigan on their 49. They've come up from their 11-yard line. 4:27 to play. The option. Leach is tackled behind the line of scrimmage. And surging in there again is Myron Lapka, number 96.
Most of the notoriety has gone to Rich Dimmler all year, but I think Myron Lapp has played about as good a football game as any down lineman out there today.
Second down, 14. Michigan band trying to get their club moving. Mitchell comes out. Rod Feaster goes in, a wide receiver, number 18. He's striking to the near side. Maybe they'll go to him. Second and 14. USC ahead, 17-10. He has the time, and he throws, and he's got his tight end again. Crossing the middle, Ricky Gray making the hit, helped by Gary Cobb. Gene Johnson, his second consecutive reception.
Kurt, we're looking at a situation now with just a little over 3 minutes to play. He's got 3rd and 8. I very much look for him to try and pick it up on 4th down if they're not successful this time. If they don't, they've really got to stop SC on a turnover.
Well, I tell you, Rick certainly has the hot hand. Everything he's been throwing is right on the money now.
Crowd roaring. 3rd down, 8. Michigan trying to put on a furious rally. Play action pass. He's going deep to Feaster. It is incomplete at the 5. Rodney Feaster was there, number 18, but he was double teamed. 4th and 8 for Michigan.
Dennis Smith had an excellent opportunity to get his 3rd interception today. He was well covered. He pumps, he throws. It's a pretty good throw. The guy never was really open. Dennis Smith played the ball all the way.
There's Feaster.
He's trying to just dissect the zone, trying to outrun it. Got fine speed. Nothing fancy about that one. You know, Rick Leach just wound up, let that Hummer go.
They are in a punt formation. Greg Wilner. Look for anything here. USC will, but it's going to be a punt. Fair catch call on the USC 15-yard line by Butler. Trojans ball. Now Michigan's hope is to hold them. Hold them deep, get the ball back again, better field position, hope for anything.
Well, I tell you, Bo obviously played for field position. He knows SC is not going to throw the ball in this series. He's going to have everybody on the line of scrimmage. Those linebackers are going to be on their toes leaning forward. SC, if they can get a first down here, could really put them in the hole. It's 2 minutes and 44 seconds left to go in the game, and Bo Schembechler has just put the game on his defensive player's shoulders.
You said that he knows SC is not going to put the ball up in the air. I think if they don't, they won't get out of that hole. I'd kind of look for him to do it.
Three timeouts left for Michigan, two for USC. Charlie White straight ahead. And Charlie White is approaching 100 yards. John Robinson.
With him there was Paul Hackett, who I think is responsible for a lot of the development of the quarterbacks at SC.
Lots moving.
The job he did on Vince Evans, the support with Bartkowski and Roth up at Cal. Excellent coach.
Charlie White again. Can't break loose. Down he goes on the 18-yard line. Look at Bo. Boy, Bo's in 10. Simpkins again. Dale Kites. Watch Simpkins.
This man has been in the action all day long. I don't know how many solo tackles he's made, but he's had a piece of that ball carrier from down one today.
They have a third down and 7. Ron Simpkins, who set the all-time record for most tackles this year. He's had 6 solos in this game. Canavino's had 3. Simpkins has had 5 assists. Third down. 7. McDonald. Off to Kane. First down. And a big first down for USC. A delay play. Lynn Kane broken. And USC keeps the ball.
All right, you're correct. They did not put the ball up in the air. They did get out of the hole on a draw play. That's good play up front.
They only made one mistake. He ran out of bounds. He should have stayed on the field of play, forced Michigan to use the timeout. He ran out of bounds, but at this point, with a minute and 24 seconds left, they're not playing defensive offense. They're going to play offense. They're going to try to get a first down. I think that's what they needed. Even if they don't get the first down, they'll punt, keep Michigan in the hole with very little time left.
A minute 24 remaining. USC ahead 17-10. In play again. Kane finding the hole. Quick start. And Canavino and Harden teamed up to take him. Now the ball is placed with a timeout called by Michigan to stop the clock with a minute 12 to go. Ball just over the 50-yard line.
All right, Michigan has 2 timeouts left. However, if they get another first down, there is not enough time to keep things going.
Let me check it. It's on the 46-yard line. All right, we're going to take a timeout here along NBC Way. 17-10 is the score. USC in the lead. We've had a look at this view here. Isn't that gorgeous? Pasadena. Right now, the view for USC is at 2nd and 2 on their 46-yard line. They're trying to keep the ball. Charlie White has a first down. They stopped the clock at the first down of the 49 of USC. Charlie White's gone over 100 yards. Lynn Kane has rushed for 90 yards. 17-10 USC, a minute 8 to go. And the Trojans are hoping to hold on. Let them vote. All the polls. Alabama won today, beating Penn State. Oklahoma, Nebraska coming up next. USC is claiming we beat Alabama at Alabama. We should be number one. That is if they hold on to this lead.
Oh, they can sit on it right now.
And now goes McDonald. 42 seconds to go. We want to thank Joe Costanza, Dr. Robert Woods, Dennis Panician, Chuck Panama, and Arthur Hoffman. All their assistants up here in the booth. And we have a timeout. The controversial touchdown we showed you, the plunge by Charlie White, in which the touchdown counted. We had one particular replay that they happened to find among all the replays with our Mully cameras that showed the ball popping out of White's hand and landing on the grass short of the goal line before he was there. But we had the hindsight and all the reruns to to judge it by.
Yeah, that hindsight is always 20-20. Right now, the foresight is very simple. Sit on the ball. There is no way they have enough timeouts to get the ball back if you don't make a critical error. John Robinson, Paul McDonald, they know they've had all they can handle this afternoon. This ball game has not been one that either team really dominated.
I believe that's Michigan's last timeout. Co-players of the game have been selected, Rick Leach and Charlie White. And they're on the cover of the Rose Bowl program. Down goes Paul McDonald. And the clock stops. This must be their last timeout. There's the time remaining, 38 seconds. Clock has stopped, 38 seconds. Incidentally, O.J. Simpson, you are hosting a big show before the Super Bowl game. January 20th.
Yeah, I'm going to be down there, down in Miami with my co-host Ted Knight. We're going to have a lot of friends down there. Bob Hope, Gary Coleman, Artie Johnson, Melvin Moore, the Rams cheerleaders. We're going to have celebrities trying to pick not only the winner of the Super Bowl, but try to name the score. People like Johnny Carson and Dean Martin and Joe Namath. We're going to be down there with, as my buddy Howard Cosell would say, a plethora of football players and entertainment celebrities.
You know what? I always heard you were a name dropper. I want to thank O.J. Simpson today for being with us. John Brody, another excellent job. And John will be the host of the Bob Hope Open along with Arnold Palmer coming up on NBC. And don't forget the Houston-Pittsburgh game in Pittsburgh next Sunday, January 7th, for the American Football Conference Championship. The winner goes to the Super Bowl in Miami. Will play the National Football Conference champ, either Los Angeles or Dallas, and it'll be on NBC. This 105,629. I know the crowd's more than that jammed in here. This is a happening in America, this Rose Bowl game.
Well, let me tell you, that crowd is like a hometown crowd for the University of Michigan. They averaged at home about 104,000 people a game. That's amazing.
This is their sixth game, O.J., that the Michigan team has played before over 100,000 people. And it looks like it's going to end up with another frustration for Bo Schembechler. He has played five bowl games, four in the Rose, one in the Orange, and has not won that last game. And yet he's had the greatest coaching record in America the last 10 years. He had his team prepared in here. They came in and played a superlative game. The USC just edged them out and edged them out on a controversial touchdown call. And there's John Robinson coming across now. 17-10, the final score. USC won it. A defensive battle in the second half, only one touchdown score.
And I think, too, right now, USC and Coach John Robinson know there's a chance that they may be voted number one. It looks to be between Alabama and USC. We'll just have to wait.
There's Bo. Great sport, Bo.
You bet. He's a very fine man.
They really are fond of each other. Robinson went to Schembechler's spring camp and to his coaching clinic and helped him. They have become very close friends since they played here in the 77 Rose Bowl.
Yeah, Robinson also says that if his son said he wanted, was recruited by Michigan, he'd tell him to go.
That's about as much as you can say about another man.
Schembechler going off, losing a hard-fought 17-10 game. There's McDonald, the quarterback, his coach Robinson. Paul McDonald has a chance to be a Rhodes Scholar here at USC in the footsteps of Pat Hayden.
He went to the same high school as Pat Hayden, Bishop Vermont.
And that's a real scholar athlete. Robinson has won his second Rose Bowl. And the crowd filing out. Nearly dark here now in Pasadena. And this was really a tough football game down here. Two offenses that averaged over 400 yards a game, and today neither could near that total. They were checked by each other's defense.
Yeah, and it was ironic. They named two offensive players as player of the game. To me, Ron Simpkins had to be one of those players. He has to get a trophy somewhere. Dennis Smith came up with two very timely interceptions. I think the defense dominated both sides of the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. But, you know, Rick Leach has had one super career here at Michigan. It's sort of sad that he has to end his career with such a controversial play, but he has a lot of football ahead of him. You know, before the game started, someone asked me if he can play pro ball, and I said I didn't think so. But Norris Reese, I didn't think he could play pro ball either. And he's excellent.
I understand that we have the USC quarterback, Paul McDonald down on the field. Paul, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Fine. What about the game, Paul?
One of the toughest games I've ever been involved in. I think Michigan had an excellent plan against us. They mixed it up really well, and I'm going to be sore tonight, believe me.
Well, you know, what did they do different? I know that you've made a career and a quick one at that. I'm sure it'll last longer. However, what were they doing defensively that kept you from being able to throw the ball to the outsides as you have been all year long?
Well, they were stunning all the time with the secondary guy in passing situations, second and eight, third and seven, whatever. And we'd send Charlie in motion to the weak side, and any time they saw that, they'd have a stunt from the other side, and they just outmanned us. We didn't really make the adjustment until later on, a mistake on our part. They may have outcoached us a little bit there. We should have just went to maximum protection and have the two wide receivers go out and run an out or run a curl or whatever, and we didn't do that.
Paul, this is OJ. You know, there was a lot of talk around the country this today who should be the national champions. Now, you knew about at the beginning of the game that Alabama won that game. Was there much conversation amongst the players about the Alabama game and this game?
Well, they were just flashing, you know, telling us the score of the Alabama-Penn State game. We really didn't care how it turned out, just the fact that we were able to play in such a great game like this and against such a fine team as Michigan was the real honor. If it happens that we end up to be national champs, then that's all the better for us.
Why only 9 passes today, Paul?
Well, I'll tell you, because of the fact that they were doing so many things like blitzing and stuff, I really didn't have that much time to throw the ball. And Lynn Cain had an outstanding game, and Charlie was running well. The middle was open, so we just took what they gave us, and that's what you have to do in any game. You just can't pass to pass. You have to do what they give you.
Paul, thank you very much. Get into your locker room. We'll see you next year, your senior year, and good luck with that outstanding scholastic average you're building.
Okay, thank you very much, Kurt and guys.
Fight on, Paul.
Paul McDonald, the quarterback. Back in 1949, they had a controversial play in the Orange Bowl. Northwestern against California. Art Murkowski fumbled as he crossed the goal line. Here's a play in the first half. Watch it now. Charlie White has the ball. Is this a touchdown or not? There's the ball. And it is. There's the ball dropped before he reaches the goal line. Definitely. On that replay, it is not a touchdown.
And they got 7 points for it. That makes it good. 17-10 USC. Sometimes you can say, hey, if you took away a touchdown, the game would have been tied or it would have gone differently. Obviously, that was a big turning point in this ball game. I don't know what would have developed had that play been called a fumble. However, I do know that USC has the skins on the wall, and that's the way it goes in this game.
Well, certainly the teams, both teams would probably have played the game a lot different if that was ruled a fumble, but I understand at halftime, I'm not sure of this. They told me it was a Big Ten official that made the call, so us out here at SC, we're a little happy that it was a Big Ten official that made that call.
Well, I've still got to tell you, you know, with all our Moly cameras, all the reruns, and you've heard so much about this in football telecasting the last year or two, it is great to have that hindsight and 30 minutes later be able to pick it out and do it. It's a lot easier to do it that
I'll
way.
I'll tell you sometimes,
call it right now.
Kurt, sometimes down in the truck they're doing a little scrambling just like we do up here in the booth. It took them 4 replays to find that baby. Harry Coyle's been doing it for years. He came up with a good shot.